crashing through the lies and disinformation. It's Alex Jones, only on the GCN Radio Network.
Here we are, broadcasting worldwide from deep in the heart of Texas, now under FEMA Region 6 dictatorship. It is Thursday, the 28th day of April, 2016. We're going to be live here for the next 4 hours as we kick off another global transmission. Wow, big broadcast today. Trump's foreign policy speech signals death of neocons and peace with Russia and others. We're going to have George Norrie coming on to talk about all these different world events, earth changes, and so much more. Mark Dice as well, and Anthony Gucciardi will quarterback the fourth hour with a lot of late-breaking news and more today. I want to play quite a few clips of the speech that Trump gave yesterday, and he did read off a teleprompter. Part of it was teleprompter. The other parts he would pause and go to his own points as he's just showing the world that he can go off of a prepared speech. The issue is everybody else can't operate without one. But still, some of that gleam being broken by him using it. But what he said was clearly written by him, and it's got the globalist in a conniption fit. We're going to be breaking that down today. All these different Council on Foreign Relations members, the head of the Kissinger group, Rothkopf, who personally, in front of the board ops and witnesses, tried to get me to join the New World Order. John Harmon heard it. Just amazing. He's come out against Trump and what he has to say about foreign policy and more. Here's why they're mad. U.S. foreign policy is to build a corporate world government for the globalist at our final expense. And I'm going to explain all this today. It's so key. They blame free market, use our engine of liberty, use our military, use our technology to take over the planet while discrediting capitalism and hanging it on the West and hanging globalism on America. Then when they're done, they release the next wave of socialist and communist collectivist young people who can't get jobs because there's no economy left by design. They then run into the next phase of the plan, total collectivism at the national level, as the, quote, solution. That then causes the total collapse of the society, and the globalists consolidate more control with authoritarianism because they're offshore, exempt from the very policies they bring into the nation. This is their exact admitted battle plan, and we're breaking it all down to here. But here is Trump absolutely destroying Hillary and Obama and the globalist foreign policy.
We're a humanitarian nation, but the legacy of the Obama-Clinton interventions will be weakness, confusion, and disarray, a mess. We've made the Middle East more unstable and chaotic than ever before. We left Christians subject to intense persecution and even genocide. We have done nothing to help the Christians, nothing. And we should always be ashamed for that lack of action. Our actions in Iraq, Libya, and Syria have helped unleash ISIS. And we're in a war against radical Islam, but President Obama won't even name the enemy. And unless you name the enemy, you will never, ever solve the problem. Hillary Clinton also refuses to say the words radical Islam, even as she pushes for a massive increase in refugees coming into our country. After Secretary Clinton's failed intervention in Libya, Islamic terrorists in Benghazi took down our consulate and killed our ambassador and three brave Americans. Then, instead of taking charge that night, Hillary Clinton decided to go home and sleep. Incredible. Clinton blames it all on a video, an excuse that was a total lie, proven to be absolutely a total lie. Our ambassador was murdered, and our secretary...
All right, we're going to go to break. That clip was recorded on an electric shaving razor, but we do have the full speech without a hum on it. We're going to be playing some clips of that here today. I'm Alex Jones, your host. Stay with us. I'm going to lay out some headlines here briefly, then I'm going to tie it all together with one story. Thank you for joining us on this Thursday edition. I'm your host, Alex Jones. We have a lot of big guests coming up today. I'll tell you about that a little bit later. Donald Trump had a very powerful 40-minute speech, obviously yesterday on foreign policy, and I agreed basically with all of it. It was classical Americana. Put America first, put our sovereignty first. Incredibly common sense, incredibly constitutional, and incredibly dangerous to the New World Order. And that's why they've had top globalists from Rothkopf to the big Rockefeller foundations, you name it. German ministers come out and attack Trump saying this was a horrible speech. The robber barons established the UN and other globalist institutions to transfer American wealth, sovereignty, power, patents, inventions into offshore combines above the law to then build an embryonic world corporate government, tax exempt. They've now basically established that, and they're now going into the phase of dismantling what's left of our industry, our power supply, our culture, our families, the most weaponized media in the world. Self-loathing guilt, hatred of the family, hatred of wealth, hatred of sovereignty, hatred of independence, hatred of honor is being injected into society. We are being dismantled. We built the world government. We built the Anglo-American empire. We paid for the whole thing, and the globalists sit offshore. Their names aren't even known. They're tax exempt. They have diplomatic immunity. And then our leaders, many of which are traitors and sold us out, they just simply graduate on to the next level of global governance on the WTO and the IMF and the World Bank boards. And they go at taxpayer expense and hang out in Davos, Switzerland with movie stars and have sex with prostitutes 4 or 5 times a day. And that's on the conservative end. Meanwhile, back here in the old empire, judge sentences serial child molester Hastert to 15 months. And they had him there in a wheelchair so we'd feel sorry for him. Hastert was recruited by the Republican Party bigwigs in Illinois to run for Congress and then within just a few years of being there be made speaker. Because they're part of a pedophile network guild. You think the Catholic Church has got pedophiles in it, folks? The same network took them over. It's taken much of the world over. And by the way, they don't just rape little kids. When you get into the higher echelons, they torture them and they slit their throats. And that's come out as well. So we're going to be talking about that. But this is the type of people we're dealing with that now run the show. And you ask, well, why would Hastert be busted? There are different battles going on within federal agencies. And so they try to send over a guy from the Army, like Petraeus, to rebalance things and make him the head of the CIA. And they set him up, you know, try to send him to jail for a few documents inside his filing cabinet. And, of course, they had the sex operatives that were attached to him blow the whistle on him. So they used sex operatives on him. He really didn't do anything. But you notice he was convicted of a felony. Hillary does things 10,000 times worse conservatively, literally tens of thousands of documents, and she doesn't get in trouble because she's an insider. But this is how they operate. And then with a Hastert, you've got other shadowy groups basically blackmailing each other saying, listen, we'll bring down your entire pedophile networks if you don't do exactly as we say. How did the new Pope, who was the black pope previously, the top Jesuit, how did he magically take over the order and now turn what Catholicism supposedly traditionally is on its head? Because they put in the networks through the Jesuit colleges of the pedophiles. They took over the Catholic Church. They then blackmailed it and took it down. You could argue whether it was good or bad in the past, and it's gone through different permutations, but now it's run by the pedophile network or by the people that put in the pedophile network. So you have to bring something down before you rebuild it in the new image. So we're going to be talking about that. We're also going to tie it into the headline, all he could say was, sex, 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 wave of refugee sex attacks hits Austria. Well, they're told, you pay $3,000 or $4,000, You get into Syria, and the smugglers from all over the world will get these people fake passports and into Germany and into Sweden and into France, and they're promised a blonde in every pot. Not a chicken in every pot like FDR promised, but a blonde in every pot, literally. And they show up saying, where's the sex? And then just start raping and robbing and pooping in the pool and just and everything. And then leftist Green Party chicks go out and give them flowers and say, I'm here to have sex with you. They're paid to do that, so that's seen on the news, so it brings more hordes in saying, oh, you do get a hot chick in every pot. And then Germany and everybody advertises, come here. They bring them in. It's a designed program to bring down society. So we're going to be going over Trump's speech, all of it. But this is the destruction of culture. Now, let's be clear. Edward Bernays, who by 1920 or so was running U.S. propaganda policy domestically and foreign, wrote three books on the subject, said, we need women in the workforce. We need to have the state take over the children as part of the eugenics plan. These are quotes. We need to totally brainwash and dumb down the public. I've been ordered and given money to do this. He had high classified rank inside the U.S. Army. You can look all this up. He goes, well, first, we don't call it Department of War. We call it Department of Peace. See, everything's flipped. Because back then, we didn't just start wars all the time, but we called it Department of War. You want a war? You got one. So it's the inversion of reality. We're going to Joe Biggs here in a moment from the Situation Room on this. And now look where women are today. Lower wages, incredible unhappiness in every statistic, breakdown of the family, things are falling apart. Women are nothing but sexual objects like they've never been before. Men have been trained to act like Arrested Development two-year-olds. And they've had the head of the Marine Corps, they've had the chairman of the Joint Chiefs, they've had them all come out in press conferences and say, this will hurt readiness and this will hurt our mission if we put women in frontline combat roles. We have to lower the size of the packs. We have to cut back. We're being ordered to lower standards. We can't do this. More than ever, the special forces do most of the work. That's why they've expanded them. And Ash Carter came out in a press conference we've got up on Infowars.com and said, look, I don't care what the heads of the joint military forces say. We're going to do this. And we'll see lots of propaganda of women carrying men around on their backs. When the truth is most men, I mean, maybe one out of 30 are able to actually compete and operate at the level of special forces. Special forces has gotten better, not worse. It's gotten just insane on its war footing and all the combat actual training. So this is about being able to draft your daughters when they come in with national conscription for 3 to 4 year forced terms domestically. And they've announced this for decades. This is the European plan as well. They're going to open it up for combat, but it's also about women just being slaves, being drafted into domestic operations and being wedded to the state. Because the state's going to give them discipline, get in their face, tell them who the boss is. But they can't have any authority or even co-parenting or a co-relationship with their man at home. And this is pure social engineering. They admitted it, just like can't say mother and father, can't say boy or girl, purple penguins. You know, if someone says there's two genders, the police are called at a college. The police say, yes, that's a hate crime. To even deny someone's existence, deny global warming, we want to arrest you. They're coming. All combat jobs open to women in the military. The Defense Department will lift all gender-based restrictions on military service starting in January. Defense Secretary Ash Carter announced today. The historic change will clear the way for women to serve in all the armed services. And it goes on from there. Carter's decision comes as a rebuke to an internal recommendation from the Marine Corps that sought to keep some jobs closed to women. In contrast, the Army leaders recommended opening up all combat jobs to women. That's not really true. They fired everybody that wouldn't. While the Marine Corps asked for a partial exemption in some areas, such as infantry, machine gunner, and fire support reconnaissance and others, we are a joint force, and I have decided to make decision which applies to all of the force, the entire force, Carter said at a Pentagon press briefing this morning. The important factor in making my decision was to have access to every American who could add strength to the joint force. That's right. Male and female fetuses also get to get harvested and sold to the highest bidder, and male and females get to work in Foxconn Apple slave factories 17 hours a day till their fingers bleed and then be forced drug and forced aborted with suicide nets. Oh, and by the way, though, they don't put women in frontline combat in China or anywhere else. And if you push gay marriage in China, they kill you. You go, but that's the progressive communists. They must be the... No, communists would never allow that because they've already taken over. This is how they collapse us. Believe me, when they're done collapsing us, there's not going to be humans in combat except for small support teams that are back from the robot force. That's all official. So, but to sabotage the human force, even though it's better overall, even the best robots they're developing and will be, they might not follow orders and they are truly autonomous to the Bill of Rights and Constitution and are actually patriots. And so they're creating an autonomous robot force that isn't really autonomous. It's been programmed by the globalists. Just like in the future, what you eat and what you do and what your job is will, quote, be from a computer, so it's non-biased. No, it's programmed by the globalists. This is the panopticon zeitgeist hellhole the UN's pushing. So it's all coming up. Joe Biggs will pop in on this. But look, they have problems with men cracking up. It's been known since the beginning of time. Women will cause big problems. The federal government has been hijacked by robber barons who are social engineers and who are beta testing the destruction of society here in the United States. And, of course, it's the so-called left that wants to make women fight in combat. They want to destroy the sacredness of femininity. They want to use women just like they've used men as slaves. Men historically and genetically, but this is also this way in much of the mammal kingdom, are the ones that go out and do the main fighting. Today, that is all being inverted because they are getting rid of humans. They're telling us the age of humans are over, so you have to pull men out of the positions of leadership in traditional male roles because you're going to put robots in those positions. Joining us to talk about this is combat veteran, Purple Heart recipient, Joe Biggs, to give us his view on this. You've heard my analysis of it, Joe, joining us from the Situation Room. What is your view on this?
I mean, it's interesting. I mean, when you inject women into combat, you're now messing with the male psyche. You're now messing with this men's primitive want to protect a woman. So when you put those women out there and they're being shot at, men aren't going to be concerned with their objectives. They're not going to be focusing in on the enemy. Instead, they're going to be worried about whether or not this female soldier is doing okay, because that's their instinctive nature to take care of them and make sure that they're all right. So it's a huge issue to bring women into this kind of role. And now they've already got women who have been passed through Ranger School. And the officer who was over the Ranger School said that these women would get through regardless. So you know that they ignored standard operating procedure. They fudge a lot of the different standards and they allow these women to go through to be PC. And now you have a House panel that's voted to make women register for the draft. Women will have to register for the Selective Service and would be eligible to be drafted in the military under provision approved by a House panel yesterday. Now, the proposal passed the House Armed Services Committee without support from its sponsor, Iraq War veteran Representative Duncan Hunter, a Republican from California. Now, he introduced this as a way to force congressional conversation about the role of women in the military, and he didn't actually think that it would get any support. And the people that actually backed him to bring this forward as a way to open up conversation and maybe sway some of these people from bringing women into combat turned on him and actually voted for it. So now women from the ages of 18 to 26 at some point will end up having to sign up for the draft. And the vote came the same day after Army officials announced that Captain Kristen Greist, one of the first women to earn a Ranger tab, will be becoming the Army's first female infantry officer. So now you've got this lady who's going to be in charge of special operations soldiers in high combat.
And let's just face it. I mean, they're not going to respect her. The guys they usually put in charge have been in like 7-8 tours, are total badasses, super smart, and still, if they screw up, people lose confidence in them. Historically, also, women get more infections. Women tend to get hysterical when other people are being killed. Women tend to have more atrocities committed by them. Once they get in an emotional state, they have three times the connections between left and right hemispheres of their brain. There's a reason no culture puts women in frontline combat, because it is a disaster.
Exactly.
And it's designed as sabotage against the U.S. military, Joe.
I mean, think about what's happened under the Obama administration thus far. You've got soldiers marching around in red high heels. You've now got women being brought in. You know, we look like a joke.
They're turning it into a huge social justice warrior re-education
camp. You've got Navy sailors on their, you know, on the ground on a boat sitting there crying. I mean, that is ridiculous. We look like a joke, and this is all part of his plan to destabilize us and make us look weak around the world.
You're absolutely right. You're going to be covering this more on the nightly news tonight and filing special reports. Other key points, Chubb.
I mean, I just don't understand how this could go by. I mean, people need to wake up and see what's going on. This is not going to help. At some point in time, we cannot let political correctness destroy our country.
But it's, as you said, though, is there any doubt it's by design? When you talk to your former soldiers, current soldiers, what is their view on this program?
Well, they're scared because when they go to these EO equal opportunity meetings that they have, they tell people how that they try to help them introduce how to ignore the fact that it's a woman there, to try to continue on with your mission, to walk a mile in their shoes, to do all this and that. And they're completely trying to turn our military into these same social justice warriors that we see in Portland and Denver and Manhattan and all over all these different rallies. It's sickening.
Joe, it's amazing that they execute homosexuals in communist countries because they claim it's a Western destabilization program. Well, I'm not saying gays themselves are evil or destabilization program, but it's true that when a government pushes all this, women in combat, can't say father and mother, I mean, this is how you kill a species. This is how you bring a society down. Joe Biggs, thanks for that information. We'll be back with the foreign policy statements of Donald Trump and so much more. A lot of key clips from his speech and the 30th anniversary of Chernobyl. Straight ahead, I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com. We're live broadcasting worldwide, ladies and gentlemen. I'm your host, Alex Jones. We have a lot of news and information to cover here today, obviously. George Norrie is going to be coming on, talking about all the different world events, Earth changes, the 30th anniversary of Chernobyl. Mark Dice is coming on to talk about the dumbing down of the public and how do you get these zombies out of trances. Some people say, well, why don't you enlighten the zombies you talk to when you go out on the street and say, let's ban dihydrogen monoxide, and 90% of them sign it in Austin, Texas, or Los Angeles, California. Why don't you tell them it's water? Because you can't educate people like that when you're awake one person at a time. You have to show everyone how dumbed down the public's gotten. So we're not there celebrating that everyone's so dumb like Jay Leno would do with jaywalking. We're there warning people that 9 out of 10 Californians, whether it's in San Diego, which is supposedly more conservative, or whether it's in L.A., say, put gun owners in forced labor camps. Or arrest people for their free speech. This is what we're dealing with. We're going to play some of these clips coming up. And Anthony Gucciardi is hosting the fourth hour. We'll have all the latest breaking news then as well. But I want to open the phones up to combat veterans and others a little bit in this hour and here in just a few minutes to specifically talk about your view of women in frontline combat. Again, this is enslaving women to the draft. The draft itself is unconstitutional, unless you're in total wartime emergency, in my view. And I don't want my daughters drafted. This is the state saying they own women. And all the things the state has done to women with forced inoculations and things all over the world, catching them, sterilizing women, it is just mind-boggling and mind-blowing that people aren't more upset about this. This is pure social engineering. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. Now, this is for veterans or current active duty. We don't have open phones right now except for folks that have been in the military and want to give their view on this, 800-259-9231. Now, also, exciting news, Anthroplex, the incredible male and female booster, but it's targeted at men, is back in stock. It's been out for months. It's amazing. It's very affordable. It's the twice-daily pill formulated for men that is designed to restore your masculine foundation. Anthroplex works by using key ingredients that you have been asking for, like horny goat weed, zinc orotate, and a newly balanced blend of other organic herbs. basically the same stuff that's in Super Male Vitality. They work together in synergy. Anthroplex was created to help fight back against the attack on men and stimulate natural vitality with its own blend of unique ingredients. This is the perfect product to pair with Super Male Vitality, which works synergistically with Anthroplex as a powerful health combo. 1-2 punch. In addition, sign up to InfoWars Underground Newsletter at InfoWars.com/newsletter and get 10% off Anthroplex delivered to your inbox. We'll send you the promo code, InfoWars.com/newsletter. We send the email out every day at about 4 o'clock. You open it up, and there is your promo code to get 10% off. Sign up for auto ship every 15, 30, 60, 90 days. Cancel anytime. Get an additional 10% off and get free shipping on orders of $50 or more. Go read the incredible 5-star reviews at InfoWarsLife.com. Super Male Vitality is about to sell out in the next few days, and unfortunately it won't be until later next month. The good news is we have plenty of Super Female Vitality that just has a couple different ingredient changes, and just quite frankly, I personally think it's just as good or better. I mean, we're so similar, but it is tailored towards women. We have that in stock. Super Male Vitality is about to sell out. We have a mega sale that will end in a few days that we only offer a few times a year on high-quality, non-GMO, super clean food produced right here in the United States by the folks at My Patriot Supply at InfoWarsSelect.com. We have their full spectrum discounted, but because I private label, I can go even lower on the exact same, just as fresh food, just a different packaging, different sticker. It's the same great packaging. That's you know, the big plastic tote containers, and that's sealed inside in their own individual packages for 30 or 40% off at InfoWarsStore.com or InfoWarsSelect.com. And obviously, that 25-year shelf life, super high quality, insurance you can eat. I hope we don't need this, but I personally am buying enough for 2 or 3 months for everybody that works at my office. And I know that's not that much when you count their families and stuff, but it's all I can afford. I'm putting in medical supplies, more firearms, more ammunition. The government, everybody says that means I'm evil or a cult. They're the ones doing it, too, and buying armored redoubts. I hope we never have to use this, but you know, the grasshopper doesn't save in the summer for the winter. The ant does. You can call me an ant all day long. So InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, Survival Shield Nascent Iodine X2, Secret 12, Vitamin B12. All this is great to stock up on. Skeletal Defense, you can get 20% off when you get that. Those two products together, bone and joint formulas, InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com. It is your purchases that make it all possible. Toll-free number again to join us. If you've been in the military and active duty service, especially in combat, all I know is women on ships. And yeah, you say, why should women have the opportunity to go out and to get a, you know, in the military and get a job and be able to get free tuition? I get there's benefits involved in all this, but it's caused tons of pregnancies, tons of court martials, sex problems. It's absolutely hamstrung the military. Other navies have very low levels of women, or they have their own Navy ships that are all women, or almost all women, or women are on one end and the men are on the other. That's why every culture does that, because we're different. That's why in most species, not just mammals, the females are in one group and the males are in another. Why is that? Because when you integrate the two completely in a forced way, it causes massive fighting. The women start fighting, the men start fighting. It's bad news, ladies and gentlemen. Very, 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 very bad news. If you take the ship, well, not really the shipwreck of the with Fletcher Christian and the Mutiny on the Bounty, which is a true story. There's a 3-book series written by some World War I aces that actually moved to those islands and studied it right after the people had you know, their children had died of Christian Fletcher and others. I'm going from memory. And there were 4 or 5 times more women than there were basically men when they'd mutinied and gone and found this uninhabited island. And all the men killed each other in just a few years. And it's because the women were pushing and wanting the men and fighting over the men. I mean, there's all sorts of weird equations and things that happen, but this is a disaster. And anyone that's managed people knows this. Anybody. Again, it is sabotage against our culture. It is so completely and absolutely out of control. And I guarantee you a Trump presidency would start reversing this. This is just wild. So we're going to talk to Garrett, a vet of the Marine Corps, John, a vet of the Navy, Jay, a Navy vet, John, a Air Force vet, and Sergeant, an Oregon vet, U.S. Army Special Forces. And I don't know who I should go to first, who's been holding the longest. Let's go to Sergeant in Oregon. Sergeant, thanks for holding her on the air.
Yeah, AJ, how you doing, buddy?
Good, thank you.
Yeah, listen, I was I did a tour in Nam, and I was with the Special Force. We ran recon up into Cambodia, seven of us up there, going up against, you know, like major troop strength coming down the trail, like 5,000 guys, and they would drop off a company, guys, just to waste us. But the women deal, I saw a lot of hardcore North Vietnamese women fighters. I mean, they were tough fighters, very, very tough, and the especially jungle fighters. But, I don't know. The women in this country, just I don't think they should be doing that kind of thing. Maybe logistics, secretaries, cooks, or something non-military. I can't imagine going and having to go into some serious combat with a woman. I just don't see that.
Well, you notice that I said women aren't good in combat units historically. Just like I'm against a draft unless we're invaded, then it's total resistance. It's time to start handing machine guns to 10-year-olds. Children, on average, a 13-year-old put in combat at age 9, anybody will tell you, and you've been in Special Forces, you know this, is meaner than like a 30-year-old Special Forces vet. They're fearless. They're crazy. Other kids get killed right next to them. They don't cry for mommy. We're killing machines, okay? Young men are the most, that's why they want them younger and younger. That's why the Chinese military has people down, you know, to age 15. The Cubans start getting people at 14 and throwing them into frontline combat. And that's because by the time they're 20 or so, they're really mean. Men are meant to start getting into war, if you're in a war, at age 10, 11, 12. Women, obviously, in a total resistance mode. I mean, hundreds of thousands of German women started fighting. They weren't even in the military once the Allies and the Russians came in. I mean, I had family members that told the stories of having to cut down German women, you know, that would be shooting at them out of doorways, you name it. So obviously, women can kill, and women can go out and do that. And the Vietnamese women were well known for that. But they were also a force where generally they were already embedded, as you knew, and were out planting rice during the day and then, you know, throwing hand grenades at you at night. But absolutely, can you imagine the decadent women we've got today, decadent men for that matter? But imagine, they're already announcing in the news they're lowering standards, lowering the training so that women can be in combat. That's wrong. There are some women who could probably perform maybe one out of a couple hundred at that level. But no, they're going to lower it. What do you say to that?
Yeah, I think you're 100% on that. The issues I've had is that this country is soft. I mean, I've been trying to get people awake, and you got people who just don't want to get up and get going and wake up, and they're just like numb. And of course, you know, the system has just dumbed us down to a level that, you know, with the chemical spraying and the television and all this stuff all these years. And I'm 70 years old. And I'm tough as a rock. I work out every day. I eat properly. I maintain my body, and I try to contain myself to a level where I can, you know, physically function at a high level. And it's just like, I just see people around me, they're just absolutely just dumbed down, and they're just out of it. I don't know. I wouldn't trust anything like that. And especially people here in this country, maybe someplace else, I don't know, but who's to say? I think in under emergency situations, maybe people would step up. I don't know.
Well, look, women never fight until the homeland's invaded, and then they do. And it's a very, very sad thing, and it shows the desperate straits people have gotten in. And I'm all about arming women and women having guns and concealed carry, and my daughters have learned how to shoot. I'm all about women taking martial arts and being tough. They sell it like, oh, you're anti-woman. You don't want women to know how to fight. Bull. But no civilized culture sticks women in frontline combat. It's stupid, it doesn't work, and it causes the destruction of morale. And absolutely, like Joe Biggs was saying, they're going to put women in command of special forces that have never even killed anybody. I mean, this is just ridiculous. I appreciate your call. And look, there are a lot of people get in the military and pass all the stuff and then go and start killing people and start sneaking up on folks and slitting their throats and things, and then they just can't handle it and get out of it. A lot of men say, look, this isn't for me. And let me tell you, statistically, women aren't going to have... You think men have PTSD when men are designed to be able to go out and kill people and gloss over it? You start putting women in there killing people? And what happens when women see a whole, let's say ISIS or Al-Qaeda shooting at you. I was told this by one special forces operator, pretty famous guy, but the stories are all classified. He's going in to kill a high-value target, leading a team in into this warehouse. And they've got rooms built into the warehouse, you know, up from the ground, management, you know, type stuff. And they got people shooting at them with machine guns, throwing hand grenades at them. They finally climb up, get around, throw hand grenades in. And guess what? Once they get inside, it's just children splattered all over the walls. They had a bunch of kids in there with them. Now, men have trouble dealing with that. What are women going to do when there's kids all over the place with their lower mandibles blown off, with their tongues flopping around, screaming mommy out of a big bloody hole in their throat? That's real footage, by the way. They're going to have a big problem. Big problem. There's a reason men commit 95% of the murders physiologically, because we're able to kill. And when we go bad, we can kill. And women don't do a lot of the killing because they're not predisposed to do it. They're not predisposed to do it. Statistically, men are the killers. Simple. Women have the babies. Men fight to protect the babies. Can't believe I have to explain this. I know our audience knows this, but folks, this isn't stupidness. This is the globalists bringing our country and our world down. The communist Chinese aren't putting women in frontline combat. They're not following all this feminist baloney because they don't want their country to fall apart. Garrett in Texas, you're on the air worldwide. Go ahead. Garrett, you're on the air. Go ahead. All right, we're going to put Garrett. Yeah, Garrett, you're listening to your radio. It's got a delay. Can you hear me now? All right, put him on hold. I'm going to go to John next here in just a moment. John in Texas, a vet of the Navy. John, what's your view on this?
Yeah, it's pretty much the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard in my life. But you and I both know, you know, they set women up for this with all these commercials showing them beating up men, killing men, all these movies. I mean, it's pretty much, you know, just like back in the day when they introduced cigarettes to females, they've just set them up for all of this stuff. And I'm going to tell you right now, if I'm a foreign a military, I would love to see women on the front line on the U.S., on the United States military team, because the first thing I would do is just wound the woman. I mean, that's very simple. And then the man is going to stop and think like, oh, crap, especially if she's yelling out to them with a blown off leg or something. He's going to stop and try to render aid, and then I'm going to get all of them. And not to mention the VA. The VA is not even set up to handle more PTSD people, and they're going to come back with huge amounts if women go to the front line. So this is a win-win for the globalists. It's going to cause a cascading effect through our military and through the United States and through our VA and everything else.
That's right. It's an ongoing sabotage of the country. Thank you. What a great caller. I got to cut you off, John, but you were incredibly accurate. Thank you for reminding me. That's why I love to take calls. Remember Private Lynch admitted it was all fake. She was ordered to lie. She didn't fight. She hid when the men fought and died and didn't even get medals. And then she was cowering under the bed when the special forces got there to the hospital where nobody had been for 2 days because the Iraqis had pulled out. And the local Iraqis had called him in, and it was run by a major film director over Sat Video, was directing the whole thing. And then they killed a bunch of members of her team that survived because they said she wasn't a hero, and then she was forced to come out and say that she wasn't a hero. That's part of the PR to sell women in the military, and that's why there's this order in Hollywood and video games and Gamergate to say that women are all the superheroes and the commanders, and why they gave, you know, 7 or 8 Oscars to that boring movie. Had some good visuals, but overall pretty stupid. Mad Max, where the men are all these babies living off the milk of mommy, and the women can just totally take all the men out. Absolute horse manure. So again, men against women, women against men, divide and conquer, pure bull. And it's just getting ready to make women total slaves of the state. Men have been war slaves for thousands of years. Now the women get to be war slaves as well. Jay, Garrett, John, and Rob, get ready. We are back live, broadcasting worldwide, taking your phone calls. Now, I want to see if Garrett is back in Texas. I'm going to try one more time. A veteran of the Marine Corps. It's the Marine Corps that has really been speaking up, and the head of the Marine Corps said this is really going to hurt things, and this is really bad. And this is not just social justice warriors at the universities, you know, wanting to have women in frontline combat. This is designed to end humans in combat. Because they do not want that anymore. They want to have a total nanny state with robots drones and automated systems controlled by the globalists in charge. That's what the megapolis is, the smart cars, the grid, the smart meters, everything. That's why you've got to get back to farming, back to ranching, back to supporting local farmers and ranchers. If you live in the big city, you've got to have maybe people you team up with and have 20, 30 acres, you know, out in a safe area with wells and crops you grow. Not to make money, but to actually persevere and create areas where normal human activity still goes on. And that's why Agenda 21 is designed to shut all that down. They call it sustainability. It's meant to make you unsustainable. Garrett in Texas, are you there?
Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, excellent. I'm sorry my phone got muted.
It's okay. Go ahead.
Very aggravating. Yes, sir. So as you know, I was in the Marine Corps. Number one thing I'd like to point out is that when you're trying out or whenever you're getting initiated in initially, you have to pass a certain requirement physically and mentally. Now, the women, I noticed, and we all knew this, and it was kind of something we didn't really care too much about or pay much notice because they weren't in combat positions. But as far as the physical attributes, they had less requirements. So if I had a man who tried out and he met the requirements of the woman's standards, he didn't get in, but the woman's is lowered, but they still get in. So that's number one. Number two, you hit something right on the nail of the head earlier, and I want to really expand upon that because this is directly connected. The military is now being turned into a social justice warrior program army for this nation. And
Because people can't refuse the orders, and so they're going to be captive with commissars, the dream, in uniform over you as change agents, making you submit to them and creating larger cadres to then go out and run the police departments and everything else. This is the fundamental takeover.
Yes, sir. And let me tell you something. When I went to boot camp, I was 100% dedicated to come and protect this country and my fellow men. They didn't need to do what they did to us at that boot camp. It is complete brainwashing. You speak in third person for 3 months, gaslighting, telling you you did something when you did it until you admit you did it. They completely break you down. They get rid of your critical thinking skills, and you wait on orders to do anything. And whenever I got stationed, just real quick, the women and the men on the Navy base, there started to be instances of the women getting broken up with by their boyfriends and then claiming sexual assault. It happened to a few people I knew. Now, once that happened, instead of being able to solve the problem like normal, a government system and the military is now completely like a controlled communist system. They simply take away the privilege of men and women being in the same rooms together. So that's one instance of problem.
When we absolutely, once they do it, it sets men and women apart. It's caused epidemics of sexual assault, both false reports, real reports. It's already destroyed much of the military, and now they're going to do it in the only really high-functioning units now, the special units, and this is the takedown. Just like they're turning off our power plants, just like they are doing college educations that are worthless by design, this country has been sabotaged to collapse into world government. Great call, Garrett. Glad we were able to get you on. Jay in Ohio and others, your calls are straight ahead. Then George Norrie joins us to break down the entire waterfront straight ahead. I'm Alex Jones. Be sure and check out InfoWarsStore.com for a wide selection of non-GMO high-quality seeds and start planting them. Now is the time to do it. The globalists cannot stand it.
Visit GCNLive.com.
They cannot stand it. Agriculture will bring them down. Talk about a crazy article up on InfoWars.com. John Boehner, former Speaker of the House, calls Ted Cruz a miserable son of a bleeper, Lucifer in the flesh. And that is the type of crazy articles that are up on InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com right now. But it is a big deal. It's all part of the social justice warrior takeover to make people basket cases, so that when they get out of college and they can't get a job, they're so mentally ill and have such chips on their shoulders, they just go take Prozac and watch cartoons all day eating GMO, waiting to get cancer and die at a young age. And so they got to learn to just obsess, freak out on each other, run around, throw fits. And they want to do that same mental illness inside the military. Because let's face it, in the last 200 years, the evolution of the modern military comes out of Prussia and the Hessians and basically war slaves who were so prestigious and esprit de corps that they were proud of the fact that they were basically trained from birth and were owned by the state and sold off to the highest bidder by the King of Prussia. and some of the other states did it as well. And that modern system got adopted. Now, the real base of it was Roman. They had that as well. You know, a lot of the Romans have their heads shaved. It was so somebody couldn't grab your hair in a fight and slit your throat or you know, use it to jerk you around with. Things like that. But in their systems, you were paid a lot by the booty, by what you conquered and were able to take over. And in the areas you were in, you could also, you know, basically feed on the local population if you wanted to a certain extent. But in your own unit or your own, you know, 100-man group with a centurion over it, the centurion almost never had to do any discipline, because if you didn't work hard and if you screwed around, they would just kill you. And they would just have a vote right there without even involving the centurion, and they would just kill you. So that's that model. And there's really still kind of that model in the military. So I guess women are going to enjoy getting, they call it, I guess the modern term since Vietnam is fragged, a fragmentation hand grenade thrown into their tent, because they're not going to sit there and let somebody slow them down. I predict women are going to be killed in large numbers when they enter frontline combat by their own units. And it's going to be, hey, sorry, honey, you know, we just can't all get killed. And, you know, you're really getting in the way. And so it's going to be a sad thing. That's what it comes down to. But that's what they do to men. And it's been done even before the Romans. War is a very dirty, vicious business. And if somebody toes the line for everybody, they'll die for them. But if somebody doesn't, they're just going to kill you. And so I predict that's what's going to happen as well. That will further degenerate. They'll be made for TV movies about it and everything, just like they were made for TV movies about Private Lynch. All made up. She cowered in fear in the resupply mission. She cowered in fear at the base. It was all lies. But in the movie, made for TV movie, she battled. The men were scared, and it was all a big PR thing. But see, the survivors started speaking out, so they all got killed. So we're going to go to John in Wisconsin, Jay in Ohio, Matt in California, Ray in Ohio. I'm going to get to your calls with Nori's on, but you probably have to hold 20 minutes or so. I know you probably want to talk to Nori. If you don't, just go ahead and hang up. Sorry I haven't gotten to you. If you'd like to hold, you can. Toll-free number on any of these topics to join and talk with us about. Nori can talk about everything. Master talk show host, second biggest talk show in the world. 16 million listeners terrestrially, about 5 million on the internet. He's hair shy being as big as Rush Limbaugh. And he's a great patriot and just a really smart guy. And he's going to be joining us coming up on the other side of this break. I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com. Well, for the balance of the hour, George Nori, who needs no introduction, will be our guest. And then we've got Mark Dice joining us with a ton of news and then your phone calls in the third hour. Then Anthony Gucciardi will host the fourth hour. I'm your host, Alex Jones. The website's InfoWars.com. There's a lot of big news there. I'm going to be going over with George Nori and getting his take on. George Nori is a Navy veteran, three-time Emmy Award winner for news coverage. Good friend of mine. And, of course, he hosts the second-largest radio show in the world, according to the ratings, Coast to Coast AM, coasttocoastam.com on almost 600 stations, or is it more than 600 stations. He's also on XM, and 37 years of broadcast experience. Beyondbelief.com is his TV show. Coasttocoastam.com is obviously the big, I almost just call it open-minded, free-thinking program where they cover everything under the sun, from the New World Order to vaccines, to earth changes, to are we alone in the universe? And I tell you, I realize that aliens are real. We're creating thousands of different chimera cross species on this planet. MIT reported this year on something I've been talking about for 20 years, because it was in the literature, it was in the medical literature, that they had facilities all over the world. Hong Kong came up a lot, China a lot, Costa Rica a lot, but now all over the U.S., where they're splicing humans and animals and then growing humanoids inside cows and sheep and goats and other things and pigs for organ harvesting. And they've made fun of me a lot in the media about this, even though you can just search part human, part animal chimeras and you'll get the different medical papers and things, but they don't show it to people yet. Now they're getting ready to. And people say, well, what about animal testing? Well, these cows and other farm animals are part human, so they don't have rights. See, there's laws for humans and laws for animals, but not laws for cross species whether it be salmon or whether it be a human, a humanoid. And so these are aliens that have been created, and they Media Matters, run by the White House and others, have done a bunch of articles making fun of us and had hundreds of newspapers write about it, going, Jones is insane and says aliens are here, that humans have been crossed with animals, and then that's alien. Well, when they create truly AI, artificial intelligence, they already have artificially intelligent autonomous systems, but it's truly conscious. The question is, has Google already really become that, interfacing with billions of humans? I believe so. They believe so. Can now predict the future. But will true AI be alien? Yes, it's silicon. It would never develop naturally here. So yes, aliens are real. They're just not the 1950s type, you know, where they attack D.C. or Mars attacks in the 1990s. Don't run. We are your friends. No, I see it more like Pacific Rim, you know, interdimensional. There's so many different ways to look at this, and George Norrie gets folks thinking about it. But I want to get into the election with him. I know he's been covering that a lot. I want to get into the state of people today. Why are people acting so whacked out? Mental illness is exploding. All this stuff's happening. People say they're so bored because people are in near trance state. The medical facts show that. We'll get George's take on that. And we'll also talk about his big paranormal date site, whatever, and then that, and his big St. Louis stage show coming up. I was at his big one in Toronto last year. That was a lot of fun. Or was it earlier this year? I forget. And so he joins us right now. George, that's quite the intro, as I tend to do. I run on at the mouth. First thing I want to ask you is, what is front and center on your mind, my friend?
Well, first of all, Alex, good to be back with you on your show.
It's good to have you. What do I have to do to get you to come on with us via Skype?
Well, we've got to do it where I can get to my office, and then we can do it. How's the quality now?
The phone's okay. It's cut down a little bit, but listen, you could load Skype on your phone, and I should have done this before the show, but let me just kiss your ring and say, please do it. If you put Skype on your iPhone or whatever you've got, we could do audio Skype with you with headphones. It'd be so good, George.
Okay, we should try that.
I promise I will send you a key lime pie if you do it.
the pie. What would you have in the pie?
I don't know. A gorgeous, gorgeous female.
But let me tell you, Alex, so much is going on this planet right now. It is absolutely unbelievable. Let's talk a little bit about the election, first of all, and what's happening now. Right now, it looks like, obviously, Donald Trump is going to be the front runner for the Republicans, though I still think it's going to be a brokered convention there. And then we've got Hillary Clinton, the front runner for the Democrats. And there's so much under the table about what she is and who she is that the American public just does not know. There's not much going on out there at all. The Trump possibilities are there because people are frustrated with everything. He may end up being a great nominee, but people just want to change. And I've never seen in my life more confusion and also more excitement about an election in all my life. How about you?
Well, I mean, I agree with you that the system's trying to force feed us. AP poll shows 6% trust in mainstream media. Where is all this collapse in confidence going, George?
It's going out the window because people are fed up with everything that's going on with America. They just don't trust government. You sense that many, many years ago when you started doing your programs, that you were way ahead of the curve. We started picking up on that. We started not downplaying the paranormal, which was a staple at Coast to Coast during Art Bell's days, but we realized, as you did, when I started having you on as a guest, that this planet is changing, and you just can't do strange ghosts and things like that all the time. You know, it's still a staple of Coast to Coast, but things are affecting people, their lifestyle, the way they live, their family, their income, their jobs. And they're frustrated. So we started to tweak and evolve Coast to Coast, much like you have tweeted InfoWars and Prison Planet. And it's become huge now. I mean, you talked about our audience. Thank you for the generosity there. But people are at a breaking point, and
It's our job, Alex. Yours, it's mine, to make sure people stay calm during these very turbulent times.
Well, it is our job, George, and I want to, again, cover just a whole bunch of issues. Radical Islam with you, where you see the world going, earth changes. But first off, Washington, D.C., I'm going to put on screen behind me footage we've shot in D.C., the richest city probably in the world, and they are so insulated. The elite believe they're in their own world. And here's Dennis Hastert, former Speaker of the House, sentenced to only 15 months for raping all these young people, all these children. It's just over the top, and this just keeps popping up. Pedophilia in D.C. And just all these other forms of corruption, and it turns out that he was recruited by Republican leadership to run for Congress to begin with out of nowhere, which shows to me it's a pedophile guild above him. Look at the Catholic Church and all these other institutions that have been infested by these people. The corruption is intensifying. What do you think about the Hastert situation?
Oh, absolutely disgusting, despicable. And, you know, it's just the tip of the iceberg. We've heard stories we haven't gone with on Coast to Coast because it's difficult to prove. But we've heard stories that some, you know, high officials go off on little junkets and trips and secret islands and covert with, you know, young people and children. And it's deplorable to me. It's truly deplorable. And something's got to be done about this. You know, Hastert's sentence is minimal with his compared to his crime. And, you know, like you just say, what has happened in the, you know, I was raised a Catholic, went to catechism classes every week. But I don't go to church like that anymore. I don't go to organized religion because what they did and how they hid this has tainted me. And it's unfortunate because there are some wonderful priests out there who are God-loving, God-fearing, care about people. But it's tainted everything.
Sure. Well, that's how you take down institutions, is getting corrupt people in place and then doling the news out that a bunch of pedophiles run the government and run the Catholic Church and run everything else, basically. Then that finally brings it down. I mean, this is really a well-thought-out plan to demoralize our country.
Well, and it is demoralizing our country. I mean, you talk to anybody out there, and aside from people who care deeply about their own families, as we all do, most people are just upset. Look at road rage, Alex. It's at an all-time high.
Let's talk about that. I'm glad that that's one of the topics you wanted to get into, is how road rage, mental illness, suicide, it's all up. People are acting crazier than ever. There's so much stress. I mean, I'm more stressed out than ever. It's this crazy artificial environment, and the system is so tenuous. Is it going to break down? I think it already is. George Norrie's our guest. When you're flying into Chicago or New York or London or other cities like Madrid, you look down and it looks like a ticking time bomb. Just hundreds of millions of people boiling around in those cities. 15, 16, 17 million. You're talking about New York City, 35 million, Mexico City, 10 million for London. And it could break down at any moment. And more the infrastructure is breaking down. More and more things are falling apart. And they're telling us austerity is here. You need to have less. And all the metrics show increased record suicide, increased record mental illness, increased breakup of families, increase of homeless. Civilization is rotting. And then you study the globalists, it's their plan to collapse it, to bring in total control, because they exempt themselves in key reservation areas from it. Now I want to get George's take. He agrees with that. George Norrie joining us. And then I also, in this brief segment, want to get his view on, because he raised it, where he thinks it's going. Because obviously this modern system, I liken it to space travel, isn't natural. And you go up in space without gravity a few years, you can't even breathe when you get back because you don't have the muscles. And I see us atrophying our humanity. How do we reverse it? What's really going on, George Norrie?
Well, I've got to tell you, Alex, social networking has been wonderful, but at the same time, it's been devastating, because what it has done is it's brought this planet much closer together in terms of news and information and immediacy. And now people who normally would not get uptight or upset about world events and go on their daily life are really frustrated just because they're being bombarded everywhere you go. I mean, look at the tragedy with Prince. When he died, like Michael Jackson, the world knew about it in 5 minutes. In the old days, my old days, when you had just the three television networks and radio, things would not happen as quickly as they do now. So the blessing is, it is great for information, but on the negative side, it's created a lot of frustrated people, and they are uptight, and it's worldwide now, as you just mentioned. It's everywhere where people are walking around looking over their shoulders because they don't know if some lunatic is about ready to belt explode themselves or if government is up to some trick to manipulate and control. And people just don't know what to do. Well, I've got some ideas on that, which we can talk about before we wrap up. But you're absolutely right. This is a prison planet.
Now, when we come back, I've got a few callers. Right before you came on, I gave the number out about women in the military, George, to give their view. Matt says he's an active duty Marine Corps captain. We know the Marine Corps itself has come out and said this is a horrible idea, overruled by Ash Carter, Secretary of Defense. They bill it like we're against women, but drafting women? I don't want my daughters being forced to the military. Plus, they admit in every culture it doesn't work. What do you think's really behind this, George Norrie? What's your view on women in the military being in frontline areas?
Well, as you said, I spent 9 years in the Navy. I've got a dear friend of mine. This woman could be Miss America. She's that gorgeous. And she got frustrated with her day-to-day activities and her job. She joined the Marines. And so this incredibly gorgeous woman is now a Marine. And she's thinking of re-upping. She was in San Diego, and she's just been sent off to Hawaii. But I've got to tell you, there is a difference between men and women. And I don't think we should be putting women on the front lines, mixing them in foxholes with guys. Look, for the history of this planet, we have gone with men as soldiers, and I don't see why that should change. Now, this is not being sexist by any means. I think women have a place everywhere, except we don't need them on the front lines. We don't need wars, but be that as it may, there are a lot of male soldiers, and we've got enough of them. We don't need women on the front
lines. Well, that's right, and look, just because somebody else can do something somebody else can't doesn't mean you have to then ban those people from being involved in something. I can't have a baby, so I shouldn't be able to sue women because they can and I can't. I mean, these are roles that we have. We're a species. CoastToCoastAM.com, George Norrie, thank you for popping in with us today. Please come on for a full hour soon via video Skype.
I'll do that. If we plan it when I'm in St. Louis, it's very easy because I've got my full studio there.
Well, I'm excited to know I'm on your show in the next few weeks. George Norrie, thank you so much. We'll talk to you soon.
Thanks, Alex.
There's George on the road. Your call's coming up, Captain Matt and others. Now, when we talk about this, when we look at this, think about the fact that we're a civilization that is able to travel outside of our planet. We're able to jump on an airplane and fly in just a few hours to the other side of the country. And the elites are saying that more and more they are going to try to restrict those type of things to the general public. And that big mass computers are going to decide where you have a job and whether you can have a car or not or what you can do. This is an automated system of total tyranny. And what they're doing is bankrupting the old free market system that created so much wealth, so they can blame the free market system for the collapse. And they have national polls out where nearly half of people under 30, millennials, 18 years to 30, say they want to have communism or socialism because capitalism doesn't work. They've gotten their degree. They can't find a job that pays the bills. They think capitalism isn't working. And now the jobs are going to be, hey, you know, join the government. Be part of a controlled, centralized system. I'm going to go to Matt, who says he's an active duty Marine Corps captain, to talk about the Secretary of Defense coming out and saying, we don't care what the Marine Corps or anybody else says. We're going to lower standards, which they've already done. And we're going to put women in frontline combat. We're going to put women in charge of men who've never been in combat. And who knows? Maybe we'll stop calling them men and women and just call them purple penguins because we live in a fruitcake cult. No, it's not a fruitcake cult. It's designed to bring down society. We're going to go to him and others in just a moment. Please don't forget today that we're running a storable food special with a super high quality, very affordable foods at InfoWarsSelect.com that is powered by My Patriot Supply, the exact same food, packaged at the exact same time, private label to us so we can do deals that nobody else can. My Patriot has the full selection at InfoWarsStore.com, their entire up-to-date catalog. It's updated weekly at the lowest prices. Already a great deal. We're able to go on average 5 to 10 to 15% under that with InfoWars Select, but we have it contractually that a few times a year we can offer 30 to 40% off depending on which package. This is the time to get storable food, InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsSelect.com, or if you have any questions, call toll-free 888-253-3139. That's 888-253-3139. We also have the best high-quality storable foods that we can ship right to you, but also survival water filters and filters you use on a daily basis, the best gravity-fed filters out there, Alexa Pure Pro, the Pro Pure, and several other great families of filters, the very best Pro Max shower filters, four-stage, fast flow, blows away what I've always used in my home to reduce the garbage you breathe or you absorb into your skin. Pro Pure Pro Max, great deal. Comparable filters are over $100. This is just a super good deal. So get ready today. Get prepared. Stop drinking the poison water. That's one of the most important things you can do. Get prepared. We've got a lot of other emergency goods as well at the highest quality, very low prices. InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsSelect.com. Go read the five-star reviews. And I want to thank all the listeners and viewers for your support. All right. You also get free shipping on orders above $50. When you sign up for AutoShip, you get an additional 10% off. If you sign up for the newsletter, InfoWars.com/newsletter, we will send you a promo code this week for 10% off Anthroplex that is back in stock as well. I'm going to stop right there. That's how we fund our operation. Please also support our local affiliates and our local sponsors or become a local sponsor or send $100 into the station manager. We're in an information war. It costs money to get this info out at every level. I know you know that. If you're a free market person that's actually worked, they want to grow up whole generations of people that never worked, never ran a business, never screwed in a light bulb, never changed a radiator, never changed a spark plug. It's scary, and I'm going to get to that after we take this round of calls, the dehumanization, what's happening with people that George Norrie was talking about earlier. But first, let's go to Matt, then we're going to go to Frank and Ray and Lucy and Bill and others. Give us your take as active duty. Wow, active duty calling in to tell us what they think. And I would imagine, Captain Matt, if I ask you why you do this, because usually active duty won't, it's because the head of the Marine Corps came out and said it's a horrible idea. And we have a foreign globalist operation that seized the country, just like Smedley Butler, the two-time Congressional Medal of Honor winner. They tried to hire him to run a secret right-wing coup to overthrow the government. He was a right-winger, so they thought he'd go along with it. But he turned out he knew the Nazis were involved. He said no and exposed the whole plan. So there's a long history in the Marine Corps of Marines saying no to foreign takeovers. And folks, that's not rhetoric when I say that. It's happening. So let's go to Matt in California. Matt, thanks for calling in.
Oh, thanks. Thanks, Alex. It's a pleasure. just to touch on something real quick, everything that you all have been discussing about women in frontline combat, it's all true. But I was a commander a couple years ago of, you know, a company-sized element. And from my perspective, the physical stuff, there's some women in the Marine Corps, Alex, they could smoke any guy. I mean, they could just flat out outperform any guy. That's just kind of a small little piece of it.
Well, sure, there are women that are amazing, amazing people, you know, at those type of skills. That's what history's shown. But generally, what do you think the whole movement's about?
Well, it's about the suits. Like I said, every time you talk to a general about one of these operations, there's always a guy in a suit sitting right beside him. It's about them taking over control and telling a general, you're going to do this. And it's not only, okay, you're going to do this, Let's just select those few women that can actually hack it and put them in there. No one would have an issue with that. What the issue is they're going to come down and say a certain percentage of your unit has to be female, and you have to accept them regardless. And even if they do come out with a qualification, they're going to schmooze them through. They do it all the time.
So it's about setting the precedent. Hey, have the new recruits wear red high heels in the Army or you're fired. It's about doing what we say when we say it, doing outlandish things, and breaking up the history of, I guess, an honorable system in our military. Is that accurate?
It's dead on the money. It's about some suit sitting beside somebody in the military and saying, do this right now or else I'll find someone that will, and then you have to do it. And the Marines resist that more than anybody else. I mean, we hate it. It's in our culture. Like, you follow Marines, you don't listen to everybody else. Everybody else is, you know, all the little sayings we have about everybody else. That's what it really boils down to. We did a test bed in D.C. where we made a whole battalion out of females and males. It was a disaster. Some of my Marines personally went and took part in it. It was an absolute disaster.
Tell us about it. I mean, break down what happened.
When you integrate on a small level, once the woman proves, she's under the gun from the start. So most of the women were under the gun from the men from the start. And then once they proved themselves, then the buddy-buddiness started. And this wasn't even in a forward deployed unit. They could still have their own bathrooms and stuff like that. Fraternization, women in charge ended up sleeping with two or three of the Marines. I mean, it was horrible. It was like good order.
Yeah, that's the paradigm we see in management, that women, it's almost like horrible bosses won. A lot of women actually act like the woman in horrible bosses one who's the dentist. And people say, oh, that must be fun. No, then they flip out on you afterwards, and then they get jealous and weird. Women in positions like that historically, look at some of the crazy queens, are even wilder than men on power trips.
Well, absolutely. And I don't want to seem like I'm bashing on the women here, because three-quarters of the problem comes from the men ourselves. It's just in our nature. Some good-looking woman's come by, she's fit, she's in shape, she's in charge, that's attractive to them. And it's across the board. It's just a bad idea. And when you're focused on the things, I've deployed three times, twice to Iraq, once to Afghanistan.
Absolutely. And look, it's not that I'm scared of women in charge. A good-looking alpha woman, there's nothing sexier. And I don't know how you can handle being around a sexy, hot alpha woman. I mean, you'd want to, obviously, it's a disaster. That's why they never did it in history.
Oh, we had they called them FETs. Female engagement teams. They would come with us on patrols. We ended up getting rid of two of them because they ended up sleeping around, cheating on their husbands, and then their commander was just, you're gone. Get out of here. So we had to search for a couple more. They can hack it. And we never had an issue with these women physically not being able to keep up or pull their own weight at all. It was all the other stuff that goes with it.
Well, let me ask you this, then. Why has the Marine Corps, according to what I read years ago, lowered standards for women, so has the Army?
They have to, or else they can't get those arbitrary numbers that were rammed down their throat. They won't get them.
So how does it work? You get a bigger group of women and then shake some of them off later and then actually find the women that can do it?
Yeah, it's just like filtering out. They do the same thing.
So even though the globals are trying to sabotage the Marine Corps, it's not working. You guys are adapting and overcoming.
Oh, we're stubborn. That's why we have a higher success rate than almost anybody else, except probably the Special Forces, because we find ways around their BS, so to speak.
That's what you got to do. And everybody has to have that will to resist the globalists. Just because they're doing all this doesn't mean they're winning. We have to resist them at every level, every day. And it's not work. It's fun to resist the globalists, folks. They want to defeat you and rub your face in the dirt, and they're not going to do it. Go ahead.
No, absolutely right. And you know, we get all of the ones we are forced to take, and then you find a reason to get rid of the ones that joined because they like men in uniform.
Let me bring this point up. What happens when frontline women get captured by jihadis and we see women on TV that are held by ISIS? What happens then?
Oh, Alex, let me tell you what. The scariest moment of my life in Afghanistan was I was an advisor when a general showed up with a female PR person. He was good-looking, blonde, blue-eyed. Really good looking. There were 1,000 Afghans looking at her like she was like wolves to a sheep. Like one little sheep walked into a wolf den. It was scary. I mean, we were terrified. And finally, the Afghan commander came over and said, get her out of here right now, or else we're going to have anarchy on this base. She would wish she was dead. I'll leave it at that.
But, I mean, that happens when a super beautiful woman, a goddess, walks into a bar, a business, anywhere. It just throws everything into disarray. And it's just biology. Why would you stick that in frontline combat? It sounds insane.
It is insane. It's somebody pushing an agenda that doesn't have to be on the ground and see the consequences.
Well,
they do it all the time.
Look, sure. The liberal minions carrying it out think they're doing social justice warrior stuff, but I'm here to tell you, Captain, at the highest levels, this is designed to finally destroy humans in combat. They've done advanced studies. They know that humans will always be integrated in with machines and will always be needed. They don't want that because you can refuse orders that are anti-human, and they want to go with an all-synthetic silicon force. That's admitted. And so they want to sabotage the military now so that in trials in the next decade, humans can be completely phased out. So I just hope the military knows this isn't just a war on the military or the U.S. This is a war on humans.
It absolutely is. And they're using more than just women to do it. It's rules of engagement. It's this. It's that. I mean, you name it. It's one little brick at a time until they see when the camel's going to
fall. That's right. The drones can kill innocent people outside of law in a country they're not allowed to be in. But if you, have to wait till you're shot at first when you see guys, pointing rifles at you.
Or they have to actually shoot at you. They can't just have the rifle. They have to actually shoot at you. And then if they drop it, you're not allowed to touch them. Exactly. Stuff like that.
That is unbelievable. Yeah, I mean, that is just... I can't believe we put up with this. I mean, this is the very government, Obama, sending people to war and then letting you get killed.
No, they don't care. You're just a number. I mean, you learn that right away. First thing you learn in the military when you're in combat, you're just a number.
Let me ask you this, Matt. What is the sense of the military right now, the Marines you talk to, others? I mean, what I've seen is folks really understand what's going on now to a great extent with all the training they've got going on for domestic operations, the rest of it. What percentage of the military is somewhat awake versus completely awake?
Honestly, Alex, it's going down. The ones that are awake are going down. Most of the really good officers I know, where you look at the guy and go, wow, this guy's amazing, they get shown the door. For one BS reason or another, they get shown the door. And it's the ones where you go, no way will that guy ever get promoted. He winds up being a major lieutenant colonel, so on and so forth.
Wow, so they're really sabotaging putting in globalist operatives.
But you could go there, yeah, with that.
But or are they just idiots that'll do whatever they're told? The recently retired military or active duty I talk to or people I run into all over the country, they are super awake to what's going on. But are you saying the purge that started the last 5-6 years is starting to have its effect in the officer corps?
Yeah, they want yes men. They want men that'll just nod their head and say, yes, I'm doing this. Most are awake and know what's going on, but you got to feed your family, You get caught in that dilemma of, are you just going to nod your head and go along with it and keep your job and keep your paycheck coming so you can take care of your family? Or are you just going to say, you know what? I've had enough. I'm walking. Push from the table and then go find something else to do where you don't have to take part in it, which that's what I'm doing right now. I've decided, you know what? If I just nod my head, I'm culpable. So not going to happen.
So are you deciding to just get out, or what are you deciding to do?
Yeah, I decided I'm going to walk. It is a hard choice, though. I mean, I'm turning down retirement. I'm turning down all these, 12 years feels like you just flushed it. But at what point you see it getting worse and worse and worse, and then you take in this election of who's going to be the commander-in-chief, you know what? It's time. Like, you come to that decision personally. How are you going to stand up and fight this? What are you going to do personally? I don't want to see it come to a shooting war in the streets. I've been through enough of that stuff in other countries.
Let me ask you this. Can you speak to any of the, because it's admitted in the newspapers, the Marines do it. I've videotaped it myself. There's been an escalation in the military trying to take on domestic operations. What's your experience with that?
Well, we do. We actually do. But typically what you will see when you see that recorded, it's what we call a MEW. It's the guys that go on ships, and you're kind of the floating emergency response team. One of the units that I'm an artillery guy, one of the things that we get tagged with is the civil operation. And you do a lot of training for that. So if like there's an earthquake or something and you go into another country, you train to, take care of riots and all that kind of stuff. However, that is easily transferable to the United States. And sometimes they take it to the next level, and they just go, well, we don't have role players from these countries, so we're just going to use U.S. people and pretend it's here. That absolutely happens.
Yes, and that's how they, at the first level, cover it and then start trying to condition people. But the good news is, for 30 years, they've been trying to train the Marines and Army to openly take out Americans, and they always have to scale back the training because people start getting really upset, and it leaks in the press. So that's the good news. Great to hear from you, Matt. God bless, and be safe. Well, there goes Matt, active duty Marine captain, with his view on women in the military. Now, we got Frank in North Carolina, Marine vet for frontline women. That's what it says on screen. We'll find out details on the other side of this break. Then we'll go to Bill in Indiana, and we'll go to Lucy in Washington and Ray in Ohio. I'm just going to you in the order in which you called. Thank you for holding. I'll try to hurry up now through your calls. That was a really interesting caller, so I had him on for like 10 minutes. And then we've got Mark Dice joining us to talk about the Prince's death, the Illuminati in Hollywood, his new book. We'll look at how Hollywood folks are trying to get out of it. We'll look at the dumbing down of the population. We'll play a bunch of clips. There is a lot coming up today I have obviously not gotten to yet. I'm Alex Jones. Thank you so much for joining us. You're listening to this transmission on the GCN Radio Network. Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com are the sites. If you're a TV viewer, I'm going to put something on screen right now. It's of a major city. I know the city, but it doesn't matter. It's like any big city of 5 or 6 million people or bigger. It's incredible to look at it at night. The airplanes coming in via time lapse, the cars racing up and down the roads, the blinking and flashing lights, millions and millions of people in unison doing different activities. It's quite a ballet. You turn the power off for 24 hours, mass looting begins. Within 5 days, murder starts ensuing. Within 10 days, most people start resorting to cannibalism. Within 16 days, over 95% do. Time bomb. Every major city needs storable foods in every home, firearms, supplies. The reason you need firearms is to keep bad guys using a crisis to steal. If the majority of people are armed and ready to defend themselves, the criminals will not dare rob anyone. But the cities like New York, Chicago, and D.C. that are some of the most dangerous have massive gun control where only the good guys are disarmed. Quite frankly, if I lived in those cities, I'd break the law and have a gun. They are time bombs. We ought to take a video like this and integrate it in with footage of blackouts that have happened before. And yes, I'm plugging right now, 30 to 40% off all the storable food at InfoWarsSelect.com, super high quality. We only do this a few times a year. It is an amazing deal. It's powered by My Patriot Supply, super high quality. We have both My Patriot Supply and InfoWars Select side by side, but ours is 30 to 40% off right now, the InfoWars Select. Special diets, 1 year supply, 2 week supply, 4 month supply, everything. It's just the widest spectrum, 72 hour kit, cook stoves, bug out packs, high-quality water filtration. It is the place to get prepared. InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com to find the nutraceuticals. All right. I'm done doing that. I want to go to Frank. Then I'm going to go to Ray, who's been on the longest. Then I'm going to go to Bill, Lucy, and Mustard. And I think you'd go to a woman first because, you know, Lucy's been holding, and she's a woman. I want to get her view on this. At least the name is a woman. And I don't want to create the crime of saying it can be somebody else's name. I can be arrested nowadays under thought crime. At least that's what they want. But, Lucy, I'll go to you actually after Frank. Frank is a Marine vet, says he's for frontline women. Tell us if I read that incorrectly, sir.
Yeah, I'm an ex-Marine infantryman. I've been out for a long time, so I actually consider myself an ex-Marine, and I know people don't like to hear that. I'm not a Marine anymore. I'm maybe a hybrid. I maybe have still some parts of, you know, the Marine Corps inside of me, I guess you never get rid of, but I consider myself to be a human now.
I understand that you're a human who was in the Marine Corps and that you understand a lot of that culture is a form of brainwashing. The difference is they're bringing in new brainwashing and licking their lips over the military. We accept some brainwashing to have a military that actually operates. And you know, these big mechanized armies are pretty unnatural. But the problem is now it's tailor-made for the real brainwashing of the globalists. Do you agree with that?
Yes. You'd be surprised too. A lot of the guys listening that have been out for a few years, they probably think they're out. They've been deprogrammed, but it takes a long time, man. It took me many, many, many years to realize just how long it lasted with me after I got out. But, you know, the thing is, I mean, I was kind of tongue-in-cheek. I was going to say that I saw it in a movie. I can't remember the name of the movie. I'm not near the internet right now, but I think it starred Demi Moore, and it seemed to have worked out pretty good there.
So of course, you're being sarcastic. That's where Demi Moore becomes a Navy SEAL and is tougher than all the guys. Are you serious to believe that, I mean, you think women in frontline combat's a good idea?
You know, I guess you could make some points off of it as far as maybe people would resist war more and demand that Congress... approve it, but
I get your angle. Hold on. I get your angle. It's kind of like saying let's have a national draft because then people won't have wars. I see where you're going with that point, but I mean, I'm just talking about the technicals of women in frontline combat. I mean, this is just completely insane. Frank, thank you. More callers, 70 seconds away. Stay with us. Mark Dice is going to be joining us in the next segment. We'll continue with your phone calls as well and intersperse a ton of news we haven't hit yet. But right now, let's go to your phone calls. Lucy in Washington. Of course, we've been talking about frontline women in the military. Is that a good idea? But Lucy just wants to talk about growing our own food and actually surviving. See, the woman doesn't want to kill everybody. She wants to grow food and save civilization. It's really satanic to put women in frontline combat in the warrior role. It'd be like trying to create artificial wombs and having it be taxpayer paid for because I feel like I'm a woman and I deserve one. That's what we're doing now with these sex changes. Totally unnatural, but this is how they're trying to sabotage us. So here I am trying to make the woman calling in talk about women in frontline combat, and she just wants to try to save the soil and humanity, I see, on the topic. But Lucy, what is your view on that?
The women in the military?
Well, frontline combat, yes.
Oh, I think that women should be, you know, raising their families and you know, paying attention to their children and their husbands, and call me old-fashioned, but you know, we survived thousands of years that way, and our country's being completely divided and destroyed because of all of these things going on in our food supply.
Oh, you said it so perfectly. Yeah, absolutely. We're being destroyed. It's by design. It's unnatural. And who's directing this? Who says? Who says with all this?
Well, it starts in the public schools at 5 years old, and they brainwash them till they're out of college, and they don't even know how to think for theirself anymore. And we're being, this is genocide, what's going on where I live. We live in a sky that is in a blanket of complete toxic waste, and it's now our soil. Lab tests have proven our soil is full of aluminum, barium, strontium, and they're putting drugs in this spray, and people are walking around like zombies. They don't even look up anymore.
So you get it. We're under globalist attack. Why are we even debating women in the front lines? This is all part of their takeover. Exactly. Everything they do is bad for us by design, packaged that it's for the greater good. Now, you called in originally about growing our own food. That is the answer, is getting self-sufficient, getting partially off the grid. The journey of a trillion miles starts with a single step, and we're doing it together. Go ahead, ma'am.
How are we going to be able to grow our own food when our soil is so contaminated it will no longer grow an organic seed? Monsanto now has aluminum-resistant seed, and they're all GMO.
And Chuck Norris sees right through it. Isn't it positive that now Chuck Norris has come out against the geoengineering? See, I mean, it's going on. They admit it's happening. They play this game and tell us it isn't. Like, you never voted. Voting never existed in the primary, silly. You know, and you know, we always sprayed stuff on you. No, you're messing with us, and we see it. I think there's a giant awakening happening. 6% of people trust the mainstream media. So that's positive news, isn't it?
Yes, it is, and I am so thankful for Chuck, and I wish that so many other famous people would come out, and I think that that's maybe why they killed Prince, is because he was talking about the geoengineering and the spraying of the planet, and the same with a lot of these other famous people. I think they were just some kind of a ritual killings or something for these evil maniacs.
Ma'am, listen. Yes, and that's why a star that isn't making money anymore is more valuable to kill, because it doubles or triples the catalog over the next decade. That has been found. That's why they killed John Lennon. It's why they killed so many other people. I've talked to top folks that are scared to death. When you're out in L.A. or New York and you're with powerful people, they all are scared to death and say that there is a mafia killing people. And you're absolutely right. That's why stars could never quit, because when they become invaluable to their managers, they get murdered. And a lot of folks will say, why am I showing DC and all this iconography? Because we're talking about the rituals. We're talking about who's in charge. We're talking about what's going on. We're talking about who the enemy is. I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com. He's got the new book out, The Illuminati in Hollywood, Celebrities, Conspiracies, and Secret Societies in Pop Culture and the Entertainment Industry. But it ties into all the social engineering. We've got a bunch of callers we'll also go to on women in the military, all these veterans calling in, commenting. But this is the takedown of society, the takedown of civilization by the ruling class. MarkDice.com is his website. He is a social media analyst, best-selling author, and, of course, Mark Dice also is a media analyst, social critic, political activist, and author. And he's also been part of a lot of national TV shows and programs, some of the same ones I've been involved in. And I like to get him on because, you know, he goes out and listen, he's not editing this other than cutting out the spaces. 8 out of 10 Austinites said that they want to kill gun owners or put them in forced labor camps. 9 out of 10 Californians he talks to, and I mean, these are folks that speak English, you know, like old white guys, like, I want to put them in, you know, put gun owners in prison. And he's like, absolutely, I'm sick of them. Let's put them all in jail. Hey, let's elect Lenin. Hey, let's, you know, just as long as you say for Obama, they're for it. Students signed petition to have gun owners executed in concentration camps. See, I was going from memory. I said they want to put us in jail. They actually pull the article up in the text of the video, and it's kill us. See, it's, people say I exaggerate. Yeah, 9 times out of 10, or even more, it's worse than I'm saying, because my own brain dials things down. It dials things down. It's like them saying 2 plus 2 equals 5. They actually teach that in Common Core. Or Obama saying raising the debt limit doesn't raise the debt limit. When I get up here and I say, Obama said raising the debt limit doesn't raise the debt limit, I feel like I'm lying and that new listeners tuning in will think I lied, because it doesn't sound real, even though I can play the clip of that exact words. Or I pledge to you, we will never have troops on the ground in Syria 16 times in 2013 and 14. Now the White House comes out and says, we never said that. That doesn't sound truthful to me, but they did it. So I wanted to say, oh, we have video of them saying kill gun owners, but I literally was about to say it. I went, no, they didn't say that. They said put us in prison. But then they put the article up, and it did say that. See, when you come face to face with a reality so insane in this complex world, with evil able to manipulate because of the complexity and hide behind it, what do you do when things are so much weirder than you can even say? 5 million Muslims, 80% of them, the EU admits, have fake passports and are, right around that number, military-age males. Everyday videos screaming, we love Hitler, Allah Akbar, give us your women, we want the sex now. Allowed to rape, the police are told don't arrest them. That's over the top, folks. It's all over the top. So Mark Dice is with us for the balance of the hour. Then Gucciardi comes in. But you look at these things that are happening. Merle Haggard comes out and sings a song about chemtrails and is dead a month later. Prince is talking about chemtrails, telling Mancow he wants to come on my show. He's dead. And they say, oh, it's an overdose. There's an autopsy, but not with Supreme Court Justice Anthony Scalia, to anglicize the name. The media always says, I don't know what I'm talking about. That's the anglicized name of Antonin as Anthony. But I am digressing. No autopsy. But it's completely normal, no autopsy. And to say it within minutes, oh, he's been found dead, totally normal, no autopsy. Oh, it was a secret society meeting, Washington Post reports, totally secret, connected to Bohemian Grove, but we can't talk about it. Before they announced that, our crew went down there and said, this is like Bohemian Grove. There's devil mask, hundreds of them, and weird effigies of demons eating children, and Joe Biggs and investigative journalist Wayne Madsen, who's in the NSA formerly, goes, I believe this is Bohemian Grove. I believe Cheney's involved. I sense him. Just the books on the bookshelf, and I don't know. And I'm like, this is during the break. I'm like, all right, Wayne, go ahead and say it. I respect you, but man, you're really going on a limb. They go on a limb, and exactly what my crew said was true. See, I'm the one going, hey, don't say it's Bohemian Grove. Come on, Alex. there's devil mask everywhere. Same people connected. I believe it's Bohemian Grove. I'm not making fun of Wayne, his voice, but that's what he sounds like. I don't even know what's going on anymore. I mean, it's getting so weird. And then Dennis Hastert is recruited out of nowhere as a high school coach to become a member of Congress by the Republican insiders. And then after only being there a few years, he's made the Speaker of the House. And folks, it keeps coming out. Most of these leaders are pedophiles. And I remember talking to people that worked at the BBC who were trying to come on my show 15 years ago to talk about Jimmy Savile. We can put him on screen if you're a TV viewer. Anybody else just Google Jimmy Savile. And they said he has necrophilia rooms at his house. They take children in and they lay plastic on the floor and bring like 8-year-old girls in drugged. And then the prime minister slits their throat in front of them and then has sex with a dead body. And then all of that started coming out in the news. He's the best friend of Prince Charles, and they keep digging up the bodies of fresh dead kids at their palaces. I don't know what's going on, folks, but man, we're in trouble, okay? Because let me tell you, they don't just want to rape kids. Sandusky was raping troubled youth that no one would believe. Same thing with this child advocate. Who would not look at Jimmy Savile and go, oh, just give your small, he liked girls. Small, he liked, reportedly slit their throats. I mean, he liked dead bodies. But the media is now admitting, okay, and yeah, killing him. As they begged, he would tell them, I am Satan. Yeah, I believe you, Savile. I believe you. Certainly you're a high-level demon. You want to know what a demon looks like that's taking full control? It's this guy. All right, I'm going to go to our guest. And who knows, maybe keep him in the next hour if Anthony wants to have Monica. I could be on for 5 hours. We ought to have him co-host sometime. This is what we're dealing with. This is the guy that had the highest level security above MI6, the royal family. Just like Sandusky, they supply kids. Sandusky was so arrogant, he would rape 10, 11, and 12-year-olds in the field house at noon. Do you know what a college field house at noon is like? A beehive, an anthill. He was supplying them to all these rich people. It's all coming. The FBI went in, the former director, to cover it up. All right. I've set the table here. I want to get into the Illuminati, what's happening. Of course they kill stars that stop making money because their catalog's worth double to triple within a few years after they're dead. It immediately makes 10, 15 times for the first month, but then it trails out. But that's why they do it. And I've talked to major Hollywood stars, major rock stars. They go, I've got to keep making money. And I go, why? And they go, because people that don't make money die. And I've been at high-level Hollywood meetings, folks, with Mark Cuban on the phone and stuff. It's been in the New York Times. People read about it. With the White House calling and saying, I'll put you in jail if you don't drop this Cuban. And then other top lawyers, like gangsters, threatening people. Going, you better watch yourself, you end up dead kid smoking cigarettes. You think this is all just patty cake out there? Now, your calls are coming up as well as the bottom of the hour. If you want to hold, if you can't, I understand callers, but I'm not disrespecting you. I appreciate you calling in when we get into the women in the military as well. But Mark Dice, so much craziness. I don't know where to start. There's so much, but you just heard what I said. What's your take on that?
You know, when you talk about such disturbing crimes, it's hard to believe that it happens at all. But for people to try to understand what it is that's going on, these sorts of things are happening within a black magic, a black sex magic Illuminati sect, because this is the only explanation for such crimes happening on such a massive and institutional level. And you talked about quite a different cases that are actually all tied together. Back in the 1980s, there were D notices which were sent, which are the equivalent of a national security letter, which is a gag order by in members of parliament who are investigating Jimmy Savile and the black sex magic child pedophile cults. So higher level members within parliament or within the justice system stopped them from investigating those individuals. And former detectives have come forward from Scotland Yard and said that there is a secret society of high-level members of parliament who murder children in satanic rituals.
And let me just stop you. If your TV viewer starts showing you inside the ranch in South Texas, 20,000 acres on the border, with the satanic mask everywhere and the little children's beds outside the room and all the rest of it. I'm going to skip this break. This is so important. You can pull up hundreds of mainstream articles now in England, in the UK, where they admit national threat, our government's run by pedophiles. Now what David Icke said 20 years ago has now all been admitted. And David Icke told me on air 15 years ago that Savelle slit children's throat with the prime minister, and I was actually delaying him editing it because it wasn't proven yet. Go ahead, Mark Dice.
Similar allegations have been made regarding elements of the Bohemian Grove. And this is detailed in my book, The Illuminati in Hollywood. And I'm not saying that every member of the Bohemian Grove participates in this.
No, it's a front for induction into the real cult.
Yeah, there's about 120 different subgroups within the Bohemian Grove.
But what happened to your reporter you sent in that got us more footage? They then set him up and put him in prison. They don't play games.
When you kick a bee's hive and you start causing a little bit too much trouble, that's when deaths start happening. So people like Michael Hastings, who was the award-winning Rolling Stone reporter who died in a mysterious car crash that appears to be from car hacking. Now, people will laugh and say that's a conspiracy theory, but much of your audience probably knows that it's a very real possibility. Automakers have come forward. Security analysts have come and said, yeah, you can hack into cars and cause them to crash. Former high-level terrorism analyst Richard Clark admitted that Michael Hastings may very well have been murdered by car hacking, but proving that's going to be almost impossible because the forensics, very difficult to prove, and convincing a jury of this is quite impossible to get them to wrap their mind around it. So essentially what's happening is at the highest levels within this invisible empire, this Illuminati mafia, which unfortunately has been morphed in the minds of the masses to convince them that it's a cool secret society of celebrities, and is the key to success, which is really just a front.
And the biggest take home from your videos that you've been making the point is, why would anyone want to be a mega celebrity? Because they're almost all slaves. They're almost all totally controlled by their managers, totally scared, and they end up dying broke. Everybody asks, why do they die broke? It's not bad business decisions most times. It's all a giant scam.
Prince realized this, and that's why when he couldn't get out of his contract disputes with Warner Brothers, he literally wrote the word slave on his cheek as he performed. Because when these stars sign those contracts, they're legally binding and obligated to perform what the contracts say, provided that it's not criminal activity. Now, so Prince, he had signed on the dotted line, and he had to perform, he had to produce new albums and new songs. And when he had disputes about this, he tried to tell the fans what was going on by writing slave on his forehead. And it gets so bad that in the contracts, and this is why I have an attorney look over a contract before I sign it with any company or appearing on any show, which costs $400 an hour just to hire an attorney to review a contract, as you know. In the contracts, They have clauses in there about arbitration. So these celebrities, most of the time, can't even sue their record labels or the studios or their boss, because in a court of law, it's public. All the evidence is public. People could come in and watch and participate and see what's happening. So in an arbitration, that's a private sort of a legal discussion. It's a private trial between judges and private arbitration firms. And so in almost every contract, literally every contract, I mean, not almost every contract, these people sign, there are arbitration clauses in there. So even if they have a dispute, they can't sue their boss because they have already agreed that they will not sue them in a court of law. They'll take them into arbitration.
But it's come out about Pelicano and all these private detectives and people that are really basically hitmen, according to the reports in entertainment. Is the real mafia is over entertainment, and I've been there. It's Jewish mafia, Italian mafia, mainly, but then they've even got bosses up above them. The CIA comes in and tells them what to put in scripts, what to do. That's now openly admitted. What did you think of the whole Beyonce situation where I said all this anti-cop stuff, all this anti-police state stuff is to make anti-police state look dumb. It's meant to cause a clash of civilizations. Her new thing is to make women hate men. Gloria Steinem was funded by the CIA. The Super Bowl is funded by the government. And I showed all the articles, and they had hundreds of publications come out and say, I was insane, Mark, but you've written books about the CIA more than anybody manipulating the media.
It's an open secret. It's confirmed on their own website. The CIA analysts who continue to work for the Entertainment Liaison Office openly admit this. And that's what I detailed in my book, The Illuminati in Hollywood. And you're very right. You articulated so well, because celebrity and Hollywood really shape the country more than Washington, D.C., and then political power, because the masses follow celebrities as if they were their gods, as if they were their parents, as if they are these all-knowing beings. And so that's why we see Beyonce chosen to perform at the Super Bowl halftime show in order to demonize police, which many police officers and captains and precincts have come out and admitted that her and the other Black Lives Matter propaganda is putting police officers at risk. Now, nobody in their right mind is supporting police brutality. There's obviously always going to be some bad apples. These are individuals who are putting their lives on the line to try to clean up a terrible and wretched society. And so the Central Intelligence Agency literally works hand in hand with Hollywood to promote certain aspects in films, in television shows. It was even admitted that the CIA worked with hip hop artists in Cuba as they were attempting to try to foment a Cuban revolution, so that the popular underground hip-hop artists in Cuba would then be fed CIA propaganda in order to participate and encourage in the Cuban revolution in order to try to topple the communist regime.
So how asinine is it when they come out and admit the Defense Department and others are funding almost everything at the halftime shows? She's clearly pushing the official Soros agenda, and then I say she should be investigated, and they act like I'm nuts. They really think their viewers and readers are idiots.
Unfortunately, that is the case. You know, you posted my latest Man on the Street Monday video where I used an old elementary school joke telling people that the word gullible had been removed from the dictionary. Now, I don't know if everybody's heard that joke, but it was an old joke from when I was a kid in elementary school. And it was, oh, really? It's been taken out of the dictionary? And then you poke fun at them and say, oh, you're so gullible, obviously. And so we have adults now that are seriously commenting. And this was the third time that I did this same segment. I also did one where I told people that they've removed the word intelligence from the dictionary. And we have adults that are out there driving vehicles and live amongst us that seriously believe and then comment on me telling them that the word gullible has been removed from the dictionary to make room for new words. And if that doesn't illustrate how dumbed down America is, I don't know what does. And my Man on the Street Monday series, the petition videos are really the most disturbing, because it's not just people commenting and showing, hey, they don't know anything, they're uninformed. These are people signing their name and other personal information on a supposed petition to enact legislation that nobody in their right mind should even consider, that anybody who has any intelligence should obviously know this is a pure joke.
We're going to play some of those clips coming up in the next segment after we take some calls. But let me ask you this question. It seems the dumbing down is accelerating, where now most people have no attention span. They don't even know where they are. Is this from television watching, or what's going on? Because it seems to be getting worse very, very quickly.
Well, social media has a lot to do with this now. I mean, we have a whole video service, Vine, which is dedicated to looping 7-second videos. So people's attention span is literally that of a goldfish, and they're entertained by little 7-second funny videos. So social media has largely destroyed the attention span. It is literally rewiring people's brains. The public now, they can only comprehend very small bits of data. Their long-term memory isn't storing data like it used to, because their conscious mind is not prioritizing it, because they think that they can just look up information on the internet or Google it. So they're not retaining information. And so they're so easily manipulated. The Man on the Street Monday petition series, which people can check out on youtube.com/MarkDice, there are, Alex, 50 different episodes now of repealing the Bill of Rights, repeal the First Amendment, give Obama immunity for any crime that he's committed, add steroids to the water supply. Any insane idea that I could come up with. So this isn't just an isolated incident of one afternoon I was able to get people to sign a petition to repeal the Bill of Rights or throw gun owners into FEMA camps and have the Marines go door to door and confiscate guns from people's homes. 50 different episodes now of crazy petitions for insane legislation.
And Mark, let me expand on this. So many ignorant trolls, and people on the street ask me too. They go, that Mark Dice guy, why does he like to make fun of people? Why is he so mean? Why doesn't he inform them? You're there, like, you know, showing in a film Appalachian children that don't know how to write. You're not putting down the Appalachian children. You're showing that they're totally ignorant. They have new studies out showing GPS is rewiring our brains to where we don't have any access to spatial direction. When I used to drive around just 4 or 5 years ago before I had GPS, I would look at the sun, where I was, what roads. I had an internal understanding. And now I notice because of GPS, I've been losing it. Just like calculators. We don't know basic math anymore. We're being killed by technology. The way it's been deployed, the way it's been rolled out, we are dying. We are falling apart. Our bone mass is going down. We are dying, Mark.
People are communicating with emojis now, which are little graphics that are supposed to depict certain emotions. And if for anybody who uses Twitter, and for those who don't know, people are communicating, you can see it, with emojis now. And instead of even texting, which is a waste of time, I mean, in a 60-second conversation over the phone, you can communicate more data than you can worth in an hour of texting back and forth. And so now people are wasting their time to scroll through their emoji keyboard to pick a photo that they feel depicts what it is that they're feeling to communicate instead of
actually using it. It is the end of the spoken word, the end of language. And they admit the language is now shrinking, which the Fabian Socialists of England, that basically run the whole show, admit is their plan. The Fabian Socialist system is a wolf in sheep's clothing because they're not socialists, they're Satanists that want to kill you and your family. I've read most of the ancient philosophers. I've probably read 500 history books, no exaggeration. And 300, 400 history books, hundreds of history magazines. And it's all really right there. If you're educated and informed, none of this is really even hidden. There were always people in the castle up the road that you didn't want to have your kids playing around it because your kids would disappear. Some of them wanted to rape and kill your kids. Other ones just wanted to torture them to death. It's the old thing of, you know, Transylvania. Don't get near Castle Dragon. Dracul. Castle Dragon now is in London, England, and it's literally Castle Dragon. King George thought he killed the dragon, but the dragon moved in later. There was earlier English and Norman royalty, but the royalty they have now is Transylvanian. And that's what I mean. Truth is so much stranger than fiction. I was eating an organic chicken leg during the break and bit my lip. You know, I'm getting in such a hurry nowadays. Mark's sitting there talking. I'm trying to eat a chicken leg, eat my lunch here on air. I get so sped up, I stutter, I falter, I bite myself, you know, in my frothing attempt to expose what's going on in my desperation. Because the general public's been dumbed down, and it's getting worse. Some people are waking up. It's a large minority. But the elite themselves are getting more delusional, more reckless. And if you study criminology, these master criminals are very OCD. But at a certain point, they start degenerating and wanting to get caught, like serial killers, because that's what they are. And they always have protection systems around them that are supposed to keep the truth from coming out, because they set up a system where they're at the top, everybody's dependent on them, and if you remove the cancer, it cuts into the flesh of the overall system and kills it. So they know what they're doing at very wicked, instinctive levels. But at a certain point, they start wars. They do crazy things that even bring them down. And I think we're reaching that point. We're going back to Mark Dice, and we've had callers forever holding. This ties into the social engineering. I want to get his take on women in the front line in the military. I'm going to give each caller about a minute, if you've been holding so long, to then get into manipulation of social media that's going on. They're incrementally turning it up. More and more restrictions, more and more squeezing, more and more censoring. When you hear Zuckerberg talk about it, he talks about, don't worry, I'm going to dial back the nationalist. Well, you know what? Let's dial them back. So Mark Dice wants to get into that. I want to play a few of these clips as well. He'll be with us a little bit in the next hour. And then Anthony Gucciardi takes over. But I think I'm going to co-host part of the next hour with Dice and Gucciardi. If he can keep going with us, I'll ask Dice right now and find out. Briefly, I'm going to go to these calls now. And I appreciate you holding patiently. Ray in Ohio, been holding forever. And Bill in Indiana. And Mustard, Craig, and Robert. And that'll be it for calls during at least the part of the show I'm hosting today. We have the fourth hour that I co-host sometimes, but normally is hosted by others because I really can't do 4 hours routinely and not descend into bedlam. But it is good to have that fourth hour. A lot of folks want it. But what's really going on with the people that run D.C.? What's really happening? What's their ultimate end game? Where are they really going? I'm going to ask Mark that question in a moment and then go right to your calls. Briefly, this is an information war, and I want to thank you all for your support. We couldn't do it without you. It's amazing what we've done, and thank you for your prayers as well. You need storable foods. You need high-quality storable foods, in my view, and this is a storable food I've chosen for my family. Very affordable, very clean, very wholesome. They have special diets, wide spectrum, My Patriot Supply. We have their whole catalog at InfoWarsStore.com. Discounted, high quality. But because I private label their entire line, I'm also, quite frankly, they're packaging it new every day. When you order it, it's drop shipped from them. They put an InfoWars sticker on it. Same package, different name, same contents. You know, same label, just different name on the label. And I can give you 30 to 40% off with specials on this. I'm normally able to discount 5 to 15%. But I'm able to do this at least twice a year. I'm trying to do it more. 30 to 40% off. We're running right now. InfoWars Select. InfoWarsSelect.com takes you right to where you can find the storable foods themselves. Great time to be involved. 10% off when you sign up for auto ship on any of the items at InfoWarsStore.com. And free shipping on orders above $50. Super Male Vitality will sell out in the next few days. Anthroplex is back in. X2 is incredible. Super Female Vitality. DNA Force is back in stock. Go read the thousands and thousands of third-party five-star reviews. I set out with the top experts to bring the true game changers because I treat others as I want to be treated. Plus, even though I was a sociopath, I want to sell you the very best stuff out there at a great price so I dominate the market. Almost no one else does that. They go, even the big manufacturers that produce quality stuff, they go, look, most big companies come to us. They want private labels. These are the big factories, and they want private labels. But they want us to just be okay, have $3 a product, then they put $10 of marketing into each bottle. Instead, you put $20 of product in and then do basically a dollar of marketing on your own show. It's total game changer, which I would just think this is what you do. This is what made America great. I mean, I don't believe in planned obsolescence either. I want to sell you something that's really high quality. I mean, if I made cars, I'd want the engine to go as long as I could get it to. But I guess I'm a weirdo. I'm going to go back to Mark Dyson. We're going right to these calls, and Mark's going to co-host with us here. Mark, what do you think the end game, the bottom of the rabbit hole, where is this going?
Ultimately, they're paving the path for this planet to be ruled by an entity, a demonic entity, the counterfeit Christ. So I believe it's quite obvious if you've been following this for any amount of time. They're destroying the very fabric of the human race, the fabric of the family, the knowledge base, the common sense, trying to...
This is how aliens masquerading as humans would hit us.
This is an entity destroying the human race to create so much chaos so that people don't know the fact from fiction, so that when this entity arrives or is manifested through his chief humanoid type of servant, the Antichrist, and announces that he's God, he will announce really that he is Lucifer, that he is Satan, here to he has overthrown the kingdom of heaven. You're seeing Bible prophecy being fulfilled, and it's going to be this liberal supposed utopia. And any conservatives, any Christians, anyone who is trying to point out or stop or slow this kind of poisoning and destruction of the human race will be targeted for termination.
Absolutely. They're going to have super high-tech drugs. They already have them that are synthetic, that quote, don't have any side effects, but takes your will, wire heads plugging in. I mean, people are going to sell out to this.
You're already seeing the viciousness and the hatred towards Christians, towards people who believe in God, towards conservatives. We can get into the social media manipulation in a minute, but the ultimate end game is to destroy the very foundation of knowledge and reality amongst the human race.
Yes.
In order to pave the path for this counterfeit Christ, the global Messiah, who will declare that he is Satan and has overthrown the evil, tyrannical Yahweh God. And he will announce that this is the new heaven and the new earth, and that anyone who's trying to stop him needs to be exterminated.
Yahweh God that has men and women together and children and beauty and honor and all the great stuff. It's all going down the tubes. The trees are going to die. The ocean's going to die. And just nothing but pot-bellied trendies flopping around worshiping the devil. God, I mean, what kind of God wants to make everybody ugly and stupid?
A demonic entity. And unfortunately, this is what's happening in society. And now social media has obviously been taken over by the big media companies.
We're going to get to that, Mark. You're awesome. Let's get to these callers. What is your view on women in the military? Briefly, then we're going to the callers.
Well, obviously, this is part of the agenda to try to break down the traditional gender roles, which, you know what? God and nature designed. So you can't argue with the creation and what we were created to do. And
yeah,
so,
no kidding. Men do the fighting. Women have the babies.
Yeah, and this, and the whole transgender bathroom issue and choose your own gender, choose your own species is symptomatic of this liberal mental disorder and the poisoning and the destruction of the minds of people. So if we're going to use liberal logic, then I guess we're going to have more women as roofers. You know, it's going to be, we should start calling it sexist when somebody says that it's a garbage man. We need more women to collect the garbage. No, we have certain roles that have society has been abiding by because those are what nature, what God designed. And so by trying to fight this design, they're really fighting against what God created.
Yeah, exactly. Women are being taken off their pedestal because the devil hates them because they're so magic and God's greatest creation, in my view. It's absolutely evil. Let's go to phone calls right now. Thank you for holding. Rand, Ohio, is a Navy vet. What a trooper. To give us your view on overruling the Marine Corps and everybody just, nope, we're going to put women in front line and make the packs a third the size, and that's just the end of it. Okay, go ahead.
Yes, Alex, I'm a Navy veteran, and I served on a destroyer back in the 1980s. And in those days, women served in a supporting role, like on supply ships rather than combat vessels. And I believe that putting women in combat roles is definitely weakens our military. One thing that the Navy drilled into you when you were receiving your training in boot camp was, and they emphasized this over and over and over, Pay attention to detail. And it wasn't about, so much folding your clothes properly or making your bunk properly. The idea was to get you to pay attention to these details so that when you got to the fleet, you didn't jeopardize the lives of your crew members because you were distracted by something. And I can tell you this, when you're out on a Navy ship for weeks at a time, if there were women on board those combat ships, you definitely would have been distracted. And it's, I think it's detrimental to the lives and to the missions of the military.
Why do you think they're doing this? To sabotage the military?
You know, I wonder about that too. You know, and my question, I guess, for Mark would be, when you watch television dramas, when you watch television sitcoms, as you've talked about, Alex, the men are always made to look like fools, like in the sitcoms. And then in the television dramas, the police dramas, the hospital dramas, you're constantly seeing men having to give an answer to women. And I wondered if Mark thought that, you know, maybe the emphasis to put women in combat roles is just an extension of this to...
The CIA created Ms. Magazine. The CIA, it's all on record, Mark.
Yeah, and again, Hollywood controls the minds of the masses, not Washington, D.C. And so that's why you see these radical feminist agendas being portrayed, the radical LGBT agenda portrayed now with gay and bisexual characters being introduced into almost every show, children's shows on the Disney Channel, etc. All part of conditioning people to accept it, because people will deny that the media affects society and say that it's just entertainment. But any serious media analyst or anyone with common sense knows that the media shapes the culture.
It's called advertising. It's just another mind game. Absolutely. Great point, Ray. Great point. Mark Dice, let's talk to Bill in Indiana. Bill, your take.
Hey, Alex. Hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I want to talk to you about, or ask Mark about what he knows about the number 11, as in the 9/11.
Yeah, why are the elites obsessed with numbers? He wants Fukushima. This is the 30th anniversary of Chernobyl. All this crazy stuff going on. It's like they're trying to kill the planet.
You know, I don't know too much about numerology, but I do know that at certain levels within the hierarchy, they are into planetary alignments and the sacred geometry. So they believe that numbers and mathematics have certain scientific power. And so whether they actually do or not, it really isn't the issue. The issue is that they believe it does. So it appears that they're following this pattern. But You know, I don't get too much into the numerology of it because there's clear evidence of you know, 9/11 cover-ups and inside jobs, but it's an interesting phenomena. Point is, these people are into the occult. They are spiritual people while denying on the surface that there is any sort of creator or any sort of spiritual connections to us, but they are covertly occult.
Well, it's just like communists for 30 years are ordered by their bosses to say they're anarchist, but then admit they're communists when they're waving red flags. It's just like they say, oh, they're atheist, but at the top, they'll tell you, no, I worship Lucifer. And so that's first how they do it, is tell you there is no God, so the state can become God. That's how this works. Bill, you had a point on Fukushima?
Yeah, Alex. We really need to talk to a guy named Kevin Blanch. He's an outstanding, he's the number one guy for nuclear activism. And he talks about the cover-up of Fukushima, that now WikiLeaks has emails from Hillary and John Holdren of Cal Berkeley, where they sent in those 32 ships from the Reagan battle group.
Oh, well, of course it's known that they knew they were getting radiated and cover that up. Yes, yes, we'll look into that. Good point. It just shows how they're killing us all, poisoning us all with GMO, but then telling us all day about our different rights. I want to go to break and come back with some more calls. But, Mark, start getting into social media manipulation.
Because social media is such an important aspect in most people's lives now, that it has been taken over by these big corporations and their terms of service, all at the Sun Valley Conference, which is the Bilderberg Group meeting for media, where they all meet together to coordinate their terms of service every July. Have the heads of the CIA and the NSA come there. And this is why these services, Twitter, Facebook, et cetera, all coordinate and have become the top social media services, coordinating their terms of service, coordinating manipulation. So because most people now in America, around the world, get their news just from their friends' Facebook feeds. So Facebook and Mark Zuckerberg, and the same with Twitter, they easily, and this is quite provable, manipulate the data that is posted on people's feeds. So, for example, if I post something on my Facebook page, which has about 150,000 people subscribed to it, if it has certain keywords in it, if it slants to a particular way, if it's trying to put out a certain piece of information that Facebook doesn't want spread, they simply won't allow that post to show up.
That's right. We now post videos of Facebook. At first, it'd be a million, 2 million, 3 million viewers. And then the algorithm kicked in. And now it won't let it be shared. Someone has to physically do it, and it'll still try to block it. And the people say, well, why don't they just kick you off? No, they want me to stay there and not go build my own thing. So I guess Matt Drudge is right, just completely leave it. But at the same time, I can go there, have a beachhead, show people how I'm being censored, and bring them back to InfoWars.com. So I'm not sure if I'm right or Drudge is right. What do you think?
Well, if they completely censor you and shut you down and ban you, that's going to create a lot more problems and a lot more, bring a lot more attention to it. And so they'll sort of let you be, but they put you off into the corner and they censor you through their algorithms. Now, for my videos, I'll post my videos on Facebook. If it's a YouTube link, they don't want people leaving Facebook, so it dumps it down the memory hole. Hardly anybody sees it. So if I upload the video to my Facebook video feed, still hardly anybody sees it. There are other channels, other Facebook pages that upload my videos, and they get 5-7 million views.
That's what I was about to say. In fact, I'm glad you said this, because we don't have an algorithm. We have our brains, which are even more advanced than that. And I've noticed that we'll put up some sensational video, gets 500,000 views, but some little channel that was never political puts it up, 5 million views, 8 million views.
Yes.
And so everybody, get our Facebook mentions, copy them to your YouTube, vice versa. Give them other headlines. Sometimes give them a weird headline. The computer won't see it, and then it goes mega viral. Absolutely, Mark.
It's amazing. You know, the petition videos that I've done on YouTube that get, you know, several hundred thousand views, people upload those on their Facebook page, and if it's not my page, they'll get 1 million, 5 million views. If I upload on mine, maybe 10,000.
Yeah, so everybody, so you're saying folks are authorized to get your videos, mine too, put them on your Facebook, put them on your YouTube, make them go viral, as long as they don't edit them, correct, Mark?
You know, I would prefer to post links or share them.
So stay there. You know, Mark just brought up something that's so important that I mean to spend more time on air. We know there are algorithms, and it's come out in the news, that say when Navy SEALs were spreading a meme that they went and fought, she stood down, they died. Just real simple little memes, little images. that Facebook would block that and not let it be shared. And that's just one known example. They do it all the time now. Zuckerberg meets with all the big, you know, communist Chinese executives to do this, and it's getting worse and worse and worse. But I've noticed if I do satirical stuff that's actually pro-establishment, the AI is smart enough to actually think, but dumb enough to understand, that I'm being pro-establishment, and suddenly that'll go viral. And again, we can look with our systems, whether it's being shared person to person or whether it's being allowed through. They will push stuff. These computers are so stupid at certain points. That's because we're thinking. The computers only work against unconscious people that aren't thinking. We can outsmart these machines, folks. I don't care how fancy they get, by changing rhythms, what we're doing. And what Mark said is so key. Now, Mark doesn't obviously bring in as much capital as we do to fund our operation. So he's like, well, I don't know if I can let everybody just have my films. I barely make anything on my Facebook or on my YouTube as it is. And I get that. But he was pointing out how his videos go more viral on other people's pages. He's been censored. He's had his stuff taken down before for simply saying, you know, that what was it, that Michael Reagan shouldn't talk about shoving hand grenades up children's rear ends or whatever it was. I'm not attacking Michael Reagan either, but it was a horrible statement. And then he got in trouble for saying, please, you know, don't call for killing people. So this is going on, but we stay there to try to keep them honest because they advertise that they're trying to be free and open and it's this commons and as long as you follow their rules, it's okay. But now they selectively enforce because Facebook says not agreeing with someone is hate speech, they might ban you. And so, oh, I put out a meme against Hillary. They let us know. You're locked off your site for one day. Do it again, it's 15 days. Then you get, I mean, I've shown this on air. Then do it again, it's 30 days. And then stuff from Facebook. You know, we're really being nice to you. And, you know, why don't you leave us alone? And then I go, oh, let me buy advertisement on Facebook. Suddenly, oh my gosh, everything's getting seen. So people don't know there's this control. Mark's just telling you, hey, it's going on. Be aware of it. So what do? All of us have to build our own website, our own platform, and then basically use it to take over these other forums and point out what's going on within them? I mean, is that the answer, or what do we do, Mark Dice?
You know, InfoWars operations is an incredible example of this because nobody tells you guys what to do or what you can't do, and you're able to use these mainstream platforms, these social media platforms to reach people, but you don't need to rely on them for your message to get out. So we need to jam the system. We need to spread through the grassroots, through old email lists, from face-to-face conversations about what it is that's going on so that we can expose this to everybody else.
You just said it. I've talked to all the top experts. Everybody's got to get on our email list, folks, because they're censoring more. That's a way very hard for them to block us. Infowars.com/newsletter. Everyone should go sign up there to get key reports, videos. But as stuff gets worse, that is so key. Mark, have you set up an email system yet?
It's on my list of things to do, but I haven't done it yet.
And I mean, I understand we're too busy fighting the globals to ever try to create, you know, just databases to market or whatever. And that's secondary for us. We're just trying to get the word out. I want everybody to know you can take any video we've made, anything we've done, put it on any video platform you want, do whatever. I don't care. Just don't claim you have ownership of it and don't edit it out of context or I will enforce my copyright and my rights. Because I've had folks try to get my videos and then say they're theirs. No, you can't do that. But if you want to take my films and put them out on Facebook or any other platform, please do it. We're in a war. Mark, sorry, go ahead.
I don't authorize that for my work because people abuse it and try to use my content to create and expand their own channel or their own Facebook page. So I do admire what it is that you're doing. I at this time, do not authorize that. I encourage people sharing the original links, but don't download and re-upload the video because what that does is it removes people who would find my channel.
No, I understand. I totally understand. But that's your way of doing it. I'm just in full attack mode here. I'm just firing in all directions, just throwing hand grenades at the enemy. And folks, I need you, the listeners, to get every video we've got, especially our Facebook mentions. Nobody's doing this. Put them on YouTube. They go mega viral. Get them. All right. Mark Dice is our guest from MarkDice.com. I'm going to have him back up, like I said, for a full hour, just talk about the book itself. But you heard him. This guy is busting his butt. It's a great book. You may already think you know all this. I read the book and learned a lot in it. It's amazing. But so much of it like gave me chills because I remember little things I picked up being in Hollywood and other places that absolutely confirmed this. It's so well researched. Infowarsstore.com needs to carry it, but it's at markdice.com right now and Amazon and places like that. We really should be carrying all of Mark's books. I know we have carried some of them. But I want to go to your calls, and I appreciate everybody that's been patiently holding, like Robert in Tennessee and Eric in Mississippi and Craig in New Mexico and Mary and others. We're going to take a few of your calls now, come back with Anthony Gucciardi for another 12 minutes with Dice and get into more of your calls and news. And David Knight's coming in with Gucciardi to cover a bunch of other breaking news. Like, let's just go to the calls at the start of the next segment because I don't want to cut people short. Let me ask you this, Mark, on other contemporary items, just in 60 seconds each, what's your view on Trump?
I think that he has the best interest in this for this country in mind. I don't think that he can be controlled. I think that he's the top threat to the establishment. I think that the Republican establishment are using, to, or not the Republican establishment, the Illuminati establishment is using Ted Cruz to fraction the party in attempts to try to get Hillary in. And if she wins, the social justice warriors and the establishment will come down and any opposition with an iron fist. Your career will be in jeopardy. Your social media accounts will be in jeopardy. Your freedom will be in jeopardy.
These are terrorists foaming at the mouth bullies. I've never seen such demonic, weird, stupider slugs.
They are vicious. They are godless. And if Hillary wins, we are all in jeopardy.
Have you seen the poor little, these are poor, dumbed-down TV head creatures, who I shouldn't even be mean to, but they're so dangerous, I have to stand against them. Have you seen the new face of social justice warriors? Paul Watson did a video of it. I forget its name. I think it's like Piggy Wiggy or something.
Trigglypuff.
What is it?
Trigglypuff.
That's right. And I mean, literally, it's like a crazy, angry feminist that is like a cartoon character of ridiculousness.
This is the symptom of the broken families of the internet age, of kids with the internet when they're 10 years old, looking at content that not even really adults should be poisoning their minds
but
with.
But it looks like a toddler throwing a fit.
You know, I think 30 years old now is the new 18-year-old, unless, you know, obviously there's going to be a small segment of society who are educated, but these social justice warrior college kids have the mentality of 10-year-olds.
They think it's good to stay kids. I mean, I'm not bragging, but I was 14 dating college chicks. I mean, I just, and that's a little more advanced than most people, but I mean, I really was. I don't understand why these people are like 30 and go, I'm still a child. I like not having responsibility. I mean, they're happy they've never done anything dangerous. I just can't believe it.
Well, that's why they want the government to be their daddy. They want the government to take care of them, to give them things, just like their parents did when they were children. The parents provide everything for the child, and so they want the government to provide, and they don't have the mental capacity to understand what it is to work hard and to be dedicated and to study and to have
the mental capacity to see a college chick and say she looks a lot better than high school girls.
The masses, the millennials, are almost fully destroyed. So thankfully, there's a small fraction of them that are around. But that's why it's good we reach these people through Twitter, through Facebook, through YouTube, to try to expose the system before it's too late, because it's getting beyond point of no return.
That's right. Mark Dice, stay there, my friend. We're going to come back with phone calls straight ahead. Mary, Robert, others, stay with us. And I want to be clear. I'm only doing what I have to do. I don't claim to have all the answers. Sometimes I know I'm unlistenable and I'm obnoxious and I'm angry, but don't ever take it for arrogance or hubris. It's commitment and doing the best I can. And all I'm asking you to do out there is to take action against these tyrants today. We're going to go to a bunch of phone calls here right now and finish up with Robert in Tennessee and Craig in New Mexico and some other folks that are holding. Mark's going to be with us till 20 after. Gucciardi's here. He's going to be having David Knight on. He's got some big breaking news. There's so much to go over. But the arrogance of the globalists will be their undoing. Flooding Europe with 5 million jihadis. Flooding us. Just can't use the word mother or father. It's meant to be outrageous. They're not wackos. They're not stupid. At the top, they are breaking our will. When they come out and say, there's no CIA involved in the media, Alex Jones is a liar. When it's all over Congress, it's all admitted. It's part of the deception. To where if you're even awake, it's meant to make you feel like no one knows, no one's going to listen to you, no one's coming to help you. Well, you know what? That's bull. You have a 6% approval rating. You have 6% trusting you. You're done. You're over. You're dishonorable. Nobody wants to freely associate with you. That's why you want to have a global dictatorship of ideas, because you can't compete with free will. The devil sells this idea that, oh, he's going to give you free will and let you to do all the fun stuff. God gives us everything good, and a man and woman can make the whole future together, and humans can build whatever we envision, and we're made in the image of God. God gives you everything and then gives you free will like the prodigal son and says, go out and do whatever you want. But here's some rules that if you violate them, there's consequences. And it's not even from God. It's the way nature and common sense works. It's all, everything God does is pure justice. I don't mean these churches that are run by devil worshipers and globalist operatives, almost every one of them on record. Little intelligence operations, you know, breaking up families, ripping off stuff, getting money, getting old people to sign over their houses. I mean, they're evil. I'm going to do some reports on some of these big churches in Austin. They need to know I'm coming for them. And that's what all this is about, is standing up to these slugs and realizing the real God of the universe is always there, even if these guys masquerade. We're going to calls and to Gucciardi, but other points you want to add to that, Mark Dice?
One more point about social media manipulation. For those who aren't familiar with Twitter, a lot of people just aren't interested and don't use it, but it's one of the most popular social media sites out there. Obviously, people's tweets are quoted on the mainstream media every day on the news. And so they have a top trend list, the top 10 list of the topics that are being tweeted about or being, you know, chatted about online. And so it used to be that those top trend results, you would click on one of the top keywords and it would take you to show you what the top tweets were, what were favorited and retweeted regarding those topics. And so we see Twitter manipulating the not only the top 10 hashtags, the top 10 results, trending results, but the topic itself, but the tweets connected to it. So for example, recently, when Chicago's Donald Trump rally was shut down by the Black Lives Matter thugs, at first, it was one of the top trends on Twitter. You click on the keyword, and it takes you to the top tweets and news stories about that and the photos. Then it showed, at first, it showed the police were being attacked. It showed police being hit in the head with bottles and the massive thug crowds that had shut the rally down. Then once Twitter insiders got word of what was going on and noticed that it was getting the word out about how vicious the liberals were, they manipulated the top search results. So my point is that since so many people rely on social media and on Twitter to get their news now, it's not an accurate portrayal of what people are talking about because they easily, and this is quite verifiable,
videos
on my YouTube channel where they quickly, in this case with the Donald Trump Chicago rally, they quickly removed the top results showing the vicious thugs who attacked police, they were bleeding in the head after getting hit with bottles and bricks. And they changed the top search results to showing links to MSNBC articles saying that Donald Trump is inciting violence. They changed the top results.
Oh, I remember. You'd go online and find the truth, and then you'd turn on and go, Donald Trump supporters attacked innocent people. Again, folks, some people say, well, I won't use Twitter. No, you've got to then get the links yourself that are the truth, hammer those out. And I see over and over again, human action overthrowing the machines. Because they may fake what's on the front page, but behind that, when you take mass action, that'll only spin that aggregate in the real aggregate. We'll end up reaching more people, and then that makes their spin obsolete. But only if you accept and don't know their spin is it successful. As I said earlier about human intelligence against the robots and humans using good tech against the infected artificial systems, we will prevail. Let's go to a phone call here. Robert in Tennessee, you're on the air with Mark Dice, Alex Jones, and Anthony Gucciardi. Come on in here anytime you want.
Hello, Mr. Jones.
Yes, go ahead.
It's coincidental that you and Mr. Dice at the top of your program mentioned the plight of the Appalachian children.
Yes.
And I myself am a refugee from Tennessee. So I'm living proof that I suppose I have the ability for abstract thought. But seriously, there's a...
Well, I wasn't putting down people in Appalachians. I'm saying, like you would show poor, starving children in the Appalachians to get help to them, you're not showing it to put the children down. You're showing it to show how far we've fallen in some cases. Just like when we show these victims of the modern television sickness, a global sickness, trendy sickness, I don't know what you call it, we show them they're just blithering demons that want to kill everyone.
There's what I represent is a member of a family that has had a male serve, fight, bleed, or die in every war this country has ever been in since 1640. That's the legacy.
Yeah, that'd be before the country, sure. That'd be the colonies. That'd be the Jamestown colony. So just to be clear, what are you getting to here on the women in the military?
So I've had an opportunity to listen to you, and you're an eloquent, animated, and profoundly compelling spokesman for your causes. You know, there's no doubt about that. So,
I'm fighting. Mark Dyson and I know we're fighting a fallen entity on this planet that wants to kill everybody. So the Bible's right. It's basically an interdimensional alien force we're fighting. I believe it. It's what it is. And I'm just here trying to, folks, this is not a game. So we can sit here all day and, you know, talk about it, but that's what we're facing. And I love the fact mainstream media makes fun of me when I say that. That's what it is, okay? The more you study this, this is not humans running this, I'll tell you right now. But Robert, so what do you think about women in the military?
Well, that's my point. Female combatants, frontline combatants, mm-hmm. should be allowed, but only in all female companies. Forgive me an opportunity to explain. There's, if you just crunch the numbers, there's billions.
No, but that's done. That's been done historically. The few times it's done, it's more successful. I got to jump, but thank you for holding to say that. Look, God bless you. I want to try to go to other calls. I want Mark to be able to finish up. I want to bring Anthony Gucciardi in here. I've studied every cosmology out there. I've studied every religion. I've studied history. I've voraciously studied. And the elites believe they're communicating with other dimensional entities that give them advanced technology and knowledge to overthrow humanity. And that they've actually made a deal to become supermen. As soon as they kill everybody, the entities are going to let them merge with machines and be gods like them. Sounds like a con game to me. But okay, whatever. First, they just got to poison and kill everybody, and then they get world dominion. Okay, sure. Sounds like a good deal when you're seancing at the Skull and Bones. I mean, this is real, folks. So whether it's real or not, they're manifesting. And then I say the Bible, everything else, fallen one with an army here to overthrow God's creation, take over. And then that's all I see the elite doing with satanic rituals all over television. Even if these devils aren't real, humans have taken this cosmology, or it's some race consciousness memory from another world, another time, whatever it is, and we're recreating it. All I know is, any way you slice this, it's going down. Mark Dyce?
Yes. And, you know, Jesus said that if you love your neighbor as yourself, you know, love God with all your heart and love your neighbor as yourself. And so it's obvious that these people are willfully violating those rules. And you're right. This is a spiritual war. And with transhumanism, it's going to merge into a scientific war as well. And it goes back to the story of the Garden of Eden. And a lot of people write it off and laugh and say it's just an old story. But it conveys eternal truths about the serpent and the fall of man and offering man to become gods.
The knowledge of good and evil. The knowledge of good and evil. We already had the knowledge of good. Now we were about to be taught the evil. Go ahead.
And in the Bible, there's a parable or a story about how the devil took Jesus up onto a mountain and offered him all the kingdoms of the world if he would bow down and worship him. And then the story is Jesus said no, obviously. And so it's quite obvious that there are people who accept that offer. And so now with transhumanism...
He said, get behind me, Satan. But go ahead.
Yeah, with transhumanism, the transhumanists are saying that the serpent or the devil in the Garden of Eden... that they believe was a real story is true, and that they will become the gods that Satan offered mankind to be, but they have to destroy God's creation and overthrow the kingdom of heaven.
And look, all they do is destroy creation while claiming they're the guardians of it, and they want a world government to protect it by reducing carbon, one of the key life force elements that we must have to survive, while they systematically destroy the planet as fast as they can.
It's quite obvious. You shall know them by their fruits, Jesus said, and their fruit is as rotten as anything you can find. And it's quite clear once you become aware of this. And so, you know, through social media now, they are manipulating the search results. And so for people who don't know how the system works, the younger generations, if they just simply click on a top trend on Twitter and they see the supposed top results.
That's a great point. Those of us that came up and saw the evolution of the internet, we all know tricks. Like if you try to go to the New York Times and it wants subscription because it's a Drudge link, you know, they're trying to block Drudge and his people and make you subscribe. Well, you just go put the thing in a search engine, Google lets you have it. Or you go to the New York Times, lets you have it. Now, I'm not saying that's that big a trick, but that's a trick. They don't know the tricks. We've got to teach everybody the tricks.
Yeah, and that's what, you know, wisdom of the elders. And so I've been doing this for 10 years. And so you see patterns the older you get. And so you can talk to 80, 90-year-olds, talk to your grandparents, your great-grandparents, your parents. And people, the older they get, they start to see patterns. And so it's the same old story going on. And it's approaching a time where the culture has gotten so rotten that they are now willfully calling for the extermination of Christians and conservatives. And through Twitter and Facebook, they have their selective, and YouTube, their selective terms of service.
Twitter and Facebook lets them, it has thousands of, say, Kill Donald Trump website, Kill Donald Trump Twitter, and they won't take it down, even when Billy Corgan says take it down.
No, and same with YouTube. We have now rap videos calling, and video blogs calling for the assassination, the murder of Donald Trump. And so Twitter won't delete those accounts, won't block them or suspend them. But if you criticize feminists or LGBT people or other minorities, and you use certain harsh language, if you use just certain words that they don't want you to use, then your accounts are often suspended and blocked. And so it's obvious this selective enforcement. We have a famous, not famous, but a well-known rapper in the rap community, Azealia Banks, a female rapper, who has called for the gang rape of Sarah Palin on Twitter. And her Twitter account doesn't get deleted, doesn't get blocked. She doesn't get suspended. She doesn't have her little blue verification check mark removed. Like the
Here's a great example. We showed the famous video weeks after everybody else showed it on purpose because we get censored on YouTube of collateral damage from the WikiLeaks, the helicopter shooting up the van full of kids. Okay? And I pointed out this is part of war. It's sad it happened. That's why we shouldn't be there to begin with. You don't blame the pilots of the helicopter. They didn't know, because the media was blaming them. You blame the illegal war. You don't blame the troops once they're there, you know, unless they're doing open war crimes, but they didn't know. The video was actually defending the troops, but against the war. So because it was a sophisticated argument that brought everybody together, that wasn't a balkanizer, they took our channel down. Now, we threatened a lawsuit. There was a big boycott. They gave it back to us. But hundreds of sites could have that. ABC, CBS, NBC, but not InfoWars. That shows the selective enforcement.
It is, and we have the conservative tech editor over at Breitbart who had his blue verification check mark removed, and they didn't suspend his account, but they just took his little verification check mark off, which indicates, for those who don't use social media, that that is actually the person, because there's a lot of fake accounts.
But then
accounts,
once that happens, they can also get rid of you when someone else claims that they're you. So that was the first step towards taking them down.
And when someone has a verification check on their account, it shows a little bit of credibility. It says, hey, this person's an important individual. Now, there are small, no-name rap stars who have their talent agencies buy their verification. And so nobody knows who these people are outside of their own circle of friends. They have no followers, but they're verified on Twitter. Now, I had a major talent agency submit a verification for me on Twitter, and they still refuse to do so. Obviously, because they don't want me to have that aura of credibility, because once you get a verified account, it gives you this aura.
Your videos have reached 500 million people or more conservatively. Your books, tens of millions. You've got multiple TV shows on cable that you're host of. And yes, you don't get the time of day. Listen, the Republicans are already trying to push us off, because I know you can get it earlier, like giving us even entrance into the deal. Now I'm going to get it through backdoor channels, but I mean, this is the crap we deal with where, oh, I'm sorry, you're not real media. You can't come to the Bob Bullock Museum and show the Mecha La Raza displays we have that say kill white people. We're not real media. We're not allowed to go see that, Mark Dice.
Meanwhile, BuzzFeed is given a table at the White House Correspondents' Dinner. It's absolutely incredible. And so, you know, social media, it emerges perhaps organically as a great way for people to communicate, but then it gets co-opted largely at the Sun Valley Conference.
What we need is something called, you know, like the free zone or real social media, where there's just basic rules on profanity or violence. But other than that, it's total free for all. That, I mean, imagine how big and popular that would be.
You know, and if you search the top trends on Facebook or on Twitter, it also gives an insight into the mind of the public, which is just mush, because the top trends are almost always celebrity news, meaningless and mindless celebrity gossip. And this is what people are paying attention to. And part of them have just checked out of the system. Reality has gotten too complicated, too depressing. They're trying to figure out how the election works and the delegates and the fraud and the manipulation. They just throw their hands up and give up.
And that's the enemy's ultimate goal. That's the enemy's ultimate goal. And then they win. But let me throw this at you. I have noticed, though, that even the people inside these companies don't even like the direction it's going. So we need to understand it's not just one monolithic evil. If you work at Google or Facebook, there's a lot of good people within the system that I've seen quietly trying to keep it somewhat free.
Even Bill Maher, a staunch liberal who hates Christians and conservative, has admitted that the, quote, gay mafia will come to destroy careers. And this is symptomatic of the social justice warriors now, when we have more and more people who are having their careers destroyed, not because they make hateful statements, but because they just simply disagreed that two people of the same sex should be able to call their relationship a marriage. In the case of the Firefox browser, Mozilla CEO and creator Brandon Eich. And we see more and more of these instances of conservatives being targeted and having the mobs gather on social media.
And that's how Mao started. It's how the Bolsheviks started. It's how the Nazis started. It's the most dangerous form of authoritarianism. The good news is, folks, they're losing. It's overwhelming. They're panicking. And a lot of these low-level social justice warriors never really had a real family. They're very sad. They think the state's their mommy. They're so pathetic. You know, we make fun of what's the person's name? What's the new one that Paul has dubbed the new leader of the...
Trigglypuff.
Pigglypuff?
Trigglypuff.
Trigglypuff. Okay. I have trouble pronouncing that. And actually, Trigglypuff is a human, and I want to invite Trigglypuff on the show. And I want to be sweet to Trigglypuff. I want to offer Trigglypuff a $5,000 scholarship cash to come to InfoWars Studios and to come here, and we want to meet with you. I want to take you to dinner. I want to humanize you. Believe me, I don't mean that patronizing. You've been in the Matrix. I got a red pill. Believe me. I actually, you know, I understand it's fun to be cynical and mean back to them, and I get why, because they're hateful and act. But that's a program, and I think we should actually love Trigglypuff. And I'm serious. So I'm going to get Paul on tomorrow, and I want Paul to fly here from England for 1 week to spend it with this young lady. I know I'm not supposed to say lady, but it's okay, sweetheart. You're a lady. You're a woman. I know they think they've destroyed you, and you think that you don't want to be a gender. You just want to fade away and join the state because they've hurt you so bad. But I actually think we should help her and bring Paul here, give her a $5,000 scholarship, first-class flight to Austin, Texas, and to try to really, really work with Trigglypuff.
You're right, and that's very, very Christ-like to do, because these people, many of them, the younger folks, they're raised in broken families. Their parents are too busy working jobs to really give these children the supervision and the guidance that they need. And so we're seeing the families progressively get worse and worse, and the children more and more detached from reality. And so their celebrities are, and the government is raising these kids, and we're seeing this disastrous effect. And so
exactly. You know,
if somebody like Saul of Tarsus can see the light of Christ and then become one of the greatest ambassadors for him, we can still reach these poor, poisoned mind people, and we can show them the truth, and we can correct them, and we can have them join the side of truth. It's not too late, but it's getting to that point.
Well, I agree. And her real handle, of course, is, put it back on screen, hipster something. Believe me, sweetheart, you're not hip. Buying into this, I mean, it is just. But I think she can be reached. They're actually putting some of the Satanists on TV. They can't be reached, but they just revel in. Her name is Hips_Stir, and she's in Amherst, MA, and we just want to invite. You're looking for a break from school, back to the Pioneer. Well, come on down here. Maybe we'll get her here with the Obama phone lady as well. Mark Dice, thank you so much, my friend. Always appreciate your hard work. The Illuminati and Hollywood book available at markdice.com. We'll talk to you again soon. Folks, you go see your videos. We didn't get to any of those. Come back with Gucciardi. In this species' history, coming from near extinction, no matter where your ancestors came from on this planet, battling the cave bears, saber-toothed cats, and the big cats in Africa, and right through Asia, and the other tribes, and the cataclysms, and the huge wildfires, and the starvation, and the disease, to rise up and now have giant glistening cities and spacecraft and science. Humans will transcend this latest hurdle. And we are so much closer to the next level. We are so much closer to the next level than what it took for us to get here. The technology we've got, when properly deployed in a debate about humanity's future and a debate about trials of passage, the opposite of an anti-state, incredibly dangerous exploration of undersea space, you name it, cheering when the big spacecraft blow up and those heroes are up there doing that, cheering when people commit to just do incredible things but by free will, cheering when we go to the next level. We're going to build statues of these people all over the universe, and we're not going to be stopped, not even in this dimension. We're going into the other dimensions. Everything. And the globalists know this. They're going to call this crazy, by the way. But I'm going to start telling folks what I really think, so just get ready. We're going to the next level. And the scum running this planet isn't going to stop us. The jealous scum says the devil is jealous of God's creation. No kidding. The devil can't build all this, folks. The devil just knows how to run around and lie like a big con artist. And it's a con artist economy versus a liberation economy. And we're going into the Renaissance, the real Renaissance. And I'm just here to tell you, I'm going to hand the baton to Anthony Gucciardi and David Knight, but powerful broadcast today, Lord willing. There's 30 minutes left. I'll be back tomorrow, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. or so. They'll do the fourth hour this weekend, 4 to 6 p.m. I intend to be in studio live, as I've been the last few weeks, 4 to 6 p.m. Central. But a lot happening. I don't even talk about half the news at Infowars.com. That's just up to you to get it out to everybody. But 97% chance Trump wins nomination before convention statistics reveal, statisticians reveal. This story should go totally viral. It is a very exciting time to be alive right now. Please support us. Get storable food. Fight for liberty. Fight because we're going to win. But also have a backup. The globalist number one tools to make you dependent. 30 to 40% off on the highest quality storable foods you'll find anywhere at InfoWarsStore.com. It's InfoWars Select, powered by My Patriot Supply. You cannot beat these deals. They're about to end in a few days. Anthroplex is back in stock. Supermel's selling out. X2 is the absolute game changer. And so many other great products like the Liver Shield, InfoWarsLife.com, or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And you can't ever have enough silver, bullet, colloidal silver. We've got the best skeletal defense is now in, and so much more. Water filtrations, the very best water filtration systems we can have. So we got five or six companies, just whatever's excellent, whatever has great test, no searching, no, they think you're dumb and just give you charcoal crap that makes it taste better. We bring you stuff that actually works. Why on earth would I sell somebody a water filter for the same price that doesn't cut everything out or go to 99.9%? There's all these companies sell these filters that cost like $20 for $200. I'm going to sell you something that costs $80 for $200, make my profit, and not get any bad mojo. People go, oh, that's a bunch of superstition. You think screwing people over is superstitious and not want to do that? When people have an attitude of screwing other people over, everybody else gets that attitude, and then I get screwed over. That's a fact. My superstition is called my instinct. And so, again, I want to thank you all for your support and salute you. We need to fill our coffers big time to fight the globalists, put our reporters all over the field as they're about to go out to California to a Trump rally. All Bilderberg coming up. We're going to cover it in Germany. Got a crew going. I might even go. We've got the RNC. I'm going. DNC. I'm going. Get ready. Infowarsstore.com. Refuel us and get products and provisions you need. We're the general store that brings you the best stuff that we believe we need. We're pretty smart. That we think you want, and you sure want it. You're getting it, and you're getting a great price. It's a win-win, and I obsess on that. But that's what we're building. The opportunities are unlimited. The pie is unlimited. If you're not a jealous bastard, if you're not afraid of success, the whole universe is in your hands right now. All right, I'm going to shut up and go to our guys here because they're ready to do an hour, and they got 40 minutes, 42 minutes now. Anthony, I tell you, a lot happening. I got to punch out and go to a meeting, but God bless you and David Knight and the rest of the crew because this is one hell of a fight we're in, and we're seeing such results in our fight. Imagine if it grows exponentially. We're only one piece of this resistance, and we're devastating the enemy. All glory goes to Jesus Christ.
You know, I'll tell you what, you said something poetic back there. You said, you talked about the species, not just individuals, how far we've come, the cataclysms we've overcome, the insanity. Can you imagine? But just in modern history, you know, our ancestors didn't work in the coal mines and get coal lung with the breaker boys sorting through the coal and break their backs. They didn't fight in world wars and get trench foot, which is one of the most horrible, disgusting things you can get. And the millions of other diseases that they contracted and the people that died, they didn't do all of that so we could do nothing. They didn't do all of that in a massive buildup for humanity.
Yeah, we're going to let them jack our water and do some social justice warrior deal where we talk about our wee-wees all day. The New World Order can go to hell.
Well, it's the inverse. I wish the New World Order
would just
built.
Kill themselves. You people are the disease. You're the problem. You want us to die? You die. You die. I don't even want to kill you, but you know what? You want to kill us? You know where this is going, don't you?
Well, go ahead, Anthony. I'm out of here. The thing in the world is when someone can hate that essence of humanity that has pushed us further over and over and over again for who knows how many years, for countless years, okay? And even just in modern times, in the 20th century, look at all the things we've been through from World War II, the horrible, horrible things that we've overcome, our ancestors have overcome. To get to this point, a buildup, a colossal, massive, cosmological buildup to the tipping point, and is what we're going to care about political correctness, or are we going to care about going to the next level? You know, are we going to care about taking humanity into total empowerment, or are we going to inverse and go back on all of the years of buildup, all of the years of transformation, all of the years of progression? And start fighting with each other and hating each other even more so than ever before in history. Yes, it's happened. I know it has. I know horrible things have happened, as I've said. But now we have the choice because we have the comfort. We have the luxury. I'm sitting here in a climate-controlled studio with nice computers and nice lights and a nice microphone. And I'm talking to you wherever you are in the entire world. You're getting instantaneous transmission of my voice into your eardrums that are vibrating and sending messages to your brain. Transcribing what I'm saying into your memories, your discernment, your understanding. Never before could this happen. What are we going to do with it, though? Because if you're sitting there, you're bored and you think life isn't interesting, some of the stuff we're going to talk about today, and David Knight, I wanted him to come in here because I talked to him and he had such insight on some of these things. We're going to talk about genome editing, driverless cars. We're going to talk about new pharmaceutical developments, medical developments. They're going in and just splicing up certain genes. And by the way, we're going to talk about the number one thing, the factor that people forget, human exploitation, because all of these things can be amazing. Driverless cars could be an amazing thing. Gene editing could be an amazing thing. But the difference is no one considers the human exploitation. When they fail to consider that, very, very bad things happen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave you with that note for a second. I'm going to play a video for you. And I'm going to play this video that Jakari did because when I looked at the video list, it just jumped out at me. I want you to consider how far we've come as a species. And I want you to consider the aim of empowerment and going to the next level and taking back everything that is ours as a species, such as the control of our system, even if it's political or whatever you may have. And I want you to consider, though, on the flip side, this. Germany is now installing traffic devices on the ground. So texters don't even have to look up from their phones when they're walking because people are getting hit by cars and killed because they can't stop texting when they're walking around. No one's even looking in front of them. If we can't even look in front of ourselves physically, how are we going to intellectually have our peripheral vision up to par? It's just totally insane. Let's go to this report. Are Americans smart enough to cross the street? Apparently, some of these Germans, they think, are not.
We've all heard of driving while distracted, but what about walking while distracted? Well, one town in Germany takes this so seriously that they're actually putting traffic control devices on the ground. So we're here at the University of Texas to see if this is a worthy initiative. Hey, how you doing today, miss?
Hi, I'm good.
We're talking to people about texting and walking, so you are a prime
so
candidate.
Funny.
Okay, so there's a town in Germany that's actually experimenting with putting traffic control devices on the ground so you wouldn't have to look up from your phone. Do you think something like that would be a good investment for the city of Austin?
Like it would be green, red, and yellow on the floor, like things to like help you go.
Like let's say if you're walking up to a stop sign or an intersection and you get to the edge and it says a big red a big red dot to tell you to stop.
I don't know if the money, how much that would take versus just like looking up from your phone. Is it? It's probably going to cost a lot to like put things like that on the floor and like make that happen everywhere.
I imagine so.
And I think it's better to like really see the nature and like not text while. I mean, we should not text while walking or driving just because there's so much better things to see.
So honestly, I also walk while I text. It can be a good idea, but I also when I'm walking, I always look at the stoplight to see is it could it walk. It can be a good idea. I don't know if it's worth the money that might be investing. I don't know how much it costs for them. That's a real question, I think.
Let's say you walk up to a stop sign. Instead of looking up from your phone to see there's a stop sign, there's like a big red dot on the ground, basically like a stop sign on the ground.
Okay. So, yeah, that works really well, I guess.
You think?
Yeah.
It honestly might be, maybe not just for the city, but definitely for the campus, because we're all college kids and we're all walking around staring at our phones. But, I really can't tell you how many times I'm walking and I trip over my own feet or I almost walk into someone because I'm guilty of it too.
Mostly the times, like at least on campus wise, like you'll run into things that, you know, like things that aren't at like a traffic intersection. So like maybe it's like a pole or something or like a person. So I don't know how effective that would be unless if you're like talking about like, you know, actually out by the road. So
okay. A lot of people are walking here with their phones on their hand and I don't know, I think it'd just be safer for them, especially in that part where there's a video of even a student being run off by a bus.
Oh, wow.
I don't know if you saw that a couple of years ago, but he was on a sword fight, not on his phone. Yeah, they have like a tradition where people stand on both sides of the street. So, but still, I see every day people walking around there with their phones on their hands, so it might be a good idea.
Hey, what about like an app? Like if you're walking on your phone and you get to a stop sign, something would pop us up, say stop. Here at the stop sign.
Oh, I don't know if that would work as efficiently than like being aware of your surroundings.
There you go.
It's not the same as like texting while driving, but I think it'd be useful to start like a health promotion campaign too.
More of an awareness campaign.
Yes.
That's fair enough. And what about something like an app? A similar situation, you're approaching a stop sign and you have like a stop sign that appears on your phone.
Yeah, I think that'd be useful. I think it's more useful to incentivize people rather than punish.
Possibly, yeah. I feel like that could be effective if, you know, it was, you know, properly, you know, designed and implemented. It could be effective.
If something popped up on your phone and it was like, stop.
Nah, that's too much. That's too much. I mean, then you'd have to download the app, and everyone doesn't have an app. It just wouldn't work. That doesn't make sense to me.
I think that's kind of a lot to put on everyone's phone, and I don't know if that, like, can you require that of someone?
It's hypothetical.
Okay, I mean, I guess it would work and prevent people from tripping over their own feet like I do a lot, so.
All right, thank you so much.
Yeah, of course.
So I wanted to play that video for you, and here's the fun thing. I'm not even calling these people stupid. I'm actually an idiot myself, and I text and do some stupid things myself, too. It's the direction that we're all heading with the idea that our ancestors didn't die in World War II and die of coal, black lung in the coal mine so that we could basically become androids and stare at our phones all day. Also, you know, David Knight's in here, and he said something interesting. How can we be trusted to drive if we can't even be trusted to walk down the street anymore? You know, I want his take on a lot of this because we were talking earlier. And I said, you know what? You should just come on the show because you have so many good responses on this. What I want to talk about is exploitation and human corruption in regards to all of the topics we're going to cover. So we talk about how we're destroyed by the lack of understanding details. Okay. So whether it's genome editing, driverless cars, you could even say social media. It's not about the concept of these things, which could be good, which could help humanity, which could enrich humanity. Everything is based on something that could be good. Instead, there's an element of human exploitation that no one seems to understand, and that tends to overshadow the good. But when people are walking around and they can't even be trusted to walk down the street, they don't understand this element of human exploitation. And that's when we get into things like this. With Europe, which is a good thing, Europe banning 2 endocrine-disrupting weed killers. These are 2 super highly popular herbicides that are known to be causing cancer, infertility, birth defects. But lobbyists and people, the element of human exploitation, they just push it along. They don't care. That's the same thing we saw with EPA. And we don't want to get into all of this. And, you know, Stat News said something interesting.
in a piece I read today that I find is highly interesting. So everyone's talking about CRISPR, this gene editing gadget. You know, it's so amazing. We can edit the genome and we're going to make a master race. It states, for all the hoopla about CRISPR, the revolutionary genome editing technology has a dirty little secret. It's a very messy business. Scientists basically whack the famed double helix with a molecular machete, often triggering the cell's DNA repair machinery to make all sorts of unwanted changes to the genome beyond what they intended. On Wednesday, researchers unveiled in Nature a significant improvement, a new CRISPR system that can switch single letters of the genome cleanly and efficiently in a way they said could reliably repair many disease-causing mutations. So here's the thing for me, and then I want your take on all of this stuff. Gene editing by itself, it's like if someone came out and said, you know, we don't really know what we're doing. instead of we want to democratize your DNA and own it and patent it and change everything and modify this food supply and everything. We don't know what we're doing, but there's hope here. Let's get some more funding. Let's look into the safety of this. Let's do some actual controlled trials. I would say, great. That's awesome. It has potential. Okay. We can't deny that. But instead, the human exploitation element, they say, wow, there's billions of dollars to be made. We need to push this through immediately. Just like the pharmaceutical drugs, they just push through and some of them fake the clinical trials. And it's found out 20, 30 years later. What? How do people not get this? Okay. Because it overshadows the good, though. It overshadows. They say, you're against driverless cars, David Knight. You're a technophobe. Or you're right. A anti-scientific if you're against this. No, we're against the human exploitation.
That's right. And when we look at the way they exploit people, how do they do it? They argue from authority, and they use the government to push these things through. And when we're talking about things like gene editing and that sort of thing, remember that the Dark Act, which is the nickname that those of us who were opposed to it called it, and of course that acronym was Denying Americans the Right to Know, okay? We had that introduced in Congress. Why did they put it in, Anthony? Because they were putting in laws at the local and state level saying, we want to know what's in our food. And so then they come out and say, we're going to pass an act that's going to give you transparency. And we're going to shut down the local safety concerns and do it at the federal level.
Exactly. You know what? I got caught up because we got so little time. There's so much more to talk about. We'll be right back after this break with a lot more. I'm Anthony Gucciardi with David Knight. This is the fourth hour of the Alex Jones Show. All right. We're back. This is Anthony Gucciardi with David Knight. And I want to let David finish his point. We got swept up by the break. First, if you go to InfoWarsLife.com, just want to let you know that Super Male Vitality is selling out. It will probably be sold out by the end of this weekend, and it's probably not going to be weeks or months before it's back. So if you want Super Male Vitality, get it on auto ship, get 10% off InfoWarsLife.com. It's an amazing product. I use it every single day. In my protein shake, you will notice the difference. Check out the hundreds of five-star reviews. It's the real deal. Now, David, before we went to break, we're talking about the element of human exploitation.
Yes.
In things like genome editing, driverless cars, food production. And you were talking about the Dark Act, which is the act, the piece of legislation that is meant to ban the possibility of GMO labeling in the United States.
That's right. And we have already, we've talked about that in the past. Many people think, well, that was done. And, you know, it actually failed at the beginning of March, and then just 3 days later, they introduced it again. It's the same thing we've seen with CISPA. As you pointed out during the break, we see this over and over again with the Keystone Pipeline. They just keep coming with this regulation. And now we're seeing the same type of thing happening with the self-driving cars, because if people become aware of what's going on, if they challenge the experts and say, wait a minute, what's really going on here? Are you really telling us the truth, or are you just doing something so you can make money and exploit people and you have absolutely no concern about their safety? That's what's behind these efforts to have labeling for GMO. And it's also the concerns that people had in California. They've seen these self-driving cars. They've seen them involved in an unusually high percentage of accidents. They saw one of them turn into a bus. And so the California Department of Motor Vehicles said, hey, we're going to have some regulations on this. We're going to make sure that we've got humans in here for a backup situation. So what do? Google goes to Washington to shut it down. The same thing Big Agra did with the GMO labels. And I think it's important for people on the left to understand this, because the opposition to the GMO push that we've got from Big Ag is coming from the left. They're the ones who stopped the Dark Act. But for the most part, many people on the left don't really understand the consequences of the self-driving cars. I'm all for better cars, just like I'm all for better food. We've had ways to modify food by selective breeding and that sort of thing. But when we start going in and manipulating at the genetic level, then we're doing something very different. We're doing transgenetic modification, taking the genes from different, completely different plants and animals, sometimes combining plants and animals together. And so that creates a whole new issue there. Just like self-driving cars, it's very different from the safety devices that have been added. So as people are starting to look at this, we saw this article that came up this weekend. Look, Mao, no hands. And they're talking about how China could leapfrog us because they're going to be able to impose regulatory mandates at the central area. And it's very much like what George W. Bush has said. Boy, I wish I was in China. I could just dictate what I want people to do and have them follow my orders. And that's what the big companies are doing. So now on the automobile side, we've got Google combining with car companies like Ford and Volvo, combining with taxi companies, Uber and Lyft, okay, coming together and saying, we want to get rid of any impediments to what we're doing at the local and the state level, because we're going to give you something that's safer. Same thing they do with the food stuff, right? So, yes.
No regulation whatsoever.
Absolutely.
And what's funny is we're saying, I think driverless cars could actually be an amazing thing.
Yeah.
Just like I think augmenting some things in the food supply, I've advanced my position on that, could be good if they were given the proper oversight and safety regulation, but they're not at all.
And if we were given a choice, okay, like they're going to do it in China, they're going to make sure that every car has these devices on it on every road. And that's what we're going to be looking at in America. They're already talking about smart cities here in Austin. They're going to mandate self-driving buses. So we'll have buses that not only are empty of passengers, they won't even have a human driver in them. And look at what happened in California where the Google car turned into the bus. It's going to literally turn into a bus now.
Well, it's a win-win right there. Well, it's interesting. Just goes to show it's all about the details, and we fail to understand the details. We fail overall, and very, very bad things happen. I'm Anthony Gucciardi and David Knight. Thank you so much for joining. I know you only got a short amount of time. I see tons of papers highlighted over there. Anyway, Alex will be back tomorrow from 11 to 2 a.m. 2 p.m., not 2 a.m., 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central Standard Time. Thanks so much for watching. Visit